for all you good, moral, Christian people who are complaining that breasts and vaginas are obscene. Hey, don't complain to me. Complain to the manufacturer, okay? And although Jesus told us not to judge, I know you're going to judge anyway, so judge sanely. Judge with your eyes open. What do you consider obscene? Is this obscene to you?
I like mine fried nice and brown.
I like mine fried upside down.
Yeah,
Don and Mike. Don and Mike.
Flip 'em.
Flop 'em.
Flop 'em.
Flip 'em. Don and Mike. Don and Mike.
You can call Don and Mike anytime. Free at 1-800-636-1067. They're ready to believe you.
It's the Don and Mike Show, and they'll say what they wish.
Where else would you rather be than right here, right now?
I'd just like to announce before we start the show today that all of the jokes that we'll be saying during today's show,
yes,
they've all been lifted from George Carlin's book,
yeah, yes.
Brain Droppings.
All right.
You know the guy from the Boston Globe?
Yes. Right,
do you know about that story?
No, I'm out of the loop.
There's some guy who works for the Boston Globe who's having his balls busted because he writes like a Larry King column, my right. Two thoughts, my two cents.
And he steals all his stuff from George Carlin?
Well, I guess the guy endorsed George Carlin's book and said this is a good book. Then he wrote a column where he steals like all the jokes from the book.
Like eight almost word-for-word lifts from
way,
the book.
Way to go. I like that. I like that a lot.
So we'll be doing the same thing today.
Very good. Cool. Good idea.
Later I'll be talking about the differences between football and baseball. That's one of his best bits.
And I'll be doing the hippy-dippy weatherman.
And now here's Roberto. Hello, Roberto.
Hi, I'm going to tell you all the places you can put your stuff. Good afternoon, Mr. and Mrs. Irajme and all the ships at sea. They're the hair and the teeth and the comedy tumor.
Yeah.
Don Geronimo and Mike O'Mara.
Thank you, Robbie Bobby Boo.
All right.
And hello, and thank you for listening coast to coast and nationwide via Vest Wood Von Darling. Don Geronimo with Mike O'Mara right here. That's why we still call it your cotton-picking Don und Mike Show.
Oh, better than apple butter on a bagel.
Better than what?
Apple butter on a bagel.
What is
it?
That's not what a George Carlin's bit. That's an original bit.
That's an original. Came right out of my small brain.
Coming to you from the dirty studios of WJFK in Washington, D.C. We do the show every day on the Westwood One Network. Hey, don't laugh. Come on. It's a real network.
Sure is.
58 affiliate stations, over 4 million listeners for that. We are eternally grateful. We thank you for listening. And here he is to my left and to your right. Once again, under the covers, Guy Birdley. Hold on there, Guy. While I tell Mom to get the kids back, please stand back while I whip this out.
Oh!
Perfectly done and execute another beautiful opening to this major market, big time radio show. There is our friend, Guy Birdsong. Hello, hi, Booze.
Hi, Don. Hi, Mike.
Hi, Buzz.
Boozito Gerdnank.
Yeah.
And today, I probably won't be able to wait until news and comment to talk about Monica.
Monica. Yes.
And all the stuff I've heard. Oh, hold on. I'll get that, Rob. Yeah.
Was that the hotline?
Yeah. Hello.
My boo-boo.
Oh, hey, everybody.
I just called to tell you happy anniversary, Sugar Bear.
Happy anniversary. Happy anniversary.
Thank you.
Happy anniversary. Happy anniversary.
It's my wife, Mrs. Robert Downey Jr. And I love you so much. Happy anniversary.
Thank you, sweetheart. We love you, too. And I got our boy back with us, finally.
Yeah, so finally my life will be complete again.
Good.
Hey, listen, right. Guess what my wife got me for my anniversary.
Ryan, you were talking about the lovely gift you got her. What did she get you?
It's something that, for me, you would never guess it.
All right, something. So you're thinking it's something far away from you.
Well, it's something that I've railed against in the past.
The full leather-bound collection of Harlequin romance novels.
No,
darn.
A golf
A golf bag.
She bought me one of those fancy pimp golf bags, like the kind I bought you.
Big leather one?
Yeah, a big ass leather one.
Oh, you got me a great one a few years back, so you're getting into it now.
Well, I don't know. At least I'll look good out there. It looks like something Velvet Jones would drive around in.
No, it doesn't. No,
with his hose.
Yeah, but it's got the logos on it, which I know you like logos on your clothing and your sporting equipment.
Yes, I love logos, man.
Titleist. I'm sorry, Titleist. I thought you pronounced it another way.
Oh, good.
Excuse me, Titleist.
Titleist, yeah. Titleist. Well, that's good. That's a good product. That's a very, very good golf. Oh, I like it when you get golf gifts.
Yeah, well, listen, I love you, honey. And,
all right, boo-boo.
We'll have a great time tonight. Happy anniversary
good.
To you.
And we'll celebrate our anniversary, and Barty's coming home.
Yeah, it'll be great. There's,
good for you guys.
There's my wife, you know, the most important person in my life. I love you so much.
Oh, gosh. I don't know what to do. Thank you.
I'll see you.
All right, goodbye.
Goodbye. Yeah. Yeah, so we made it through 17.
Seven? Right. You know.
And for some reason, 17 years sounds like a... Today's show today, as a matter of fact, that I saw Katie Couric just busting the balls of this guy from the Boston Globe.
About the George Carlin thing?
Yeah, now, listen, in the scheme of things, with all the stuff going on in the world, who cares if the guy, he writes a column that has like 100 little... kooky one-liners in it.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
And four or five of them he plagiarized from George Carlin's book. And because of that, I guess they fired his ass from the Boston Globe. Yes,
under a tremendous amount of pressure, I guess, to produce every single day.
She was going at him today. Mm-hmm. They had the split screen thing. So he's in a studio in Boston, and she was just in that...
This is after he's been canned that she's taking him on.
Yeah.
Now, is he protesting his firing?
He's appealing it.
Oh, he's appealing it? Okay.
Like to the publisher or something.
Right. Mm-hmm. Yes.
And then, did you see the headline in, what's that tabloid we got today, Rob?
Oh.
In the Globe? The headline in the Globe has a picture of Katie Couric.
Right.
And the headline says, "I have to tell the truth. I'm in love with Matt."
No way.
Oh, that's good.
No way. Oh, yeah, regular viewers of that show know that's not true.
Listen, big show today. Oh, I wish my wife was still on the phone because I did want to yell at her. You know what she did?
What?
She did all the good stuff with a power washer.
You didn't use the power washer?
Well, I tried to use it last week when I got... you see there on my hand, the remnants of the blister.
I still don't understand that tool. Did you do it when you were trying to start it? Is that how you got the blister?
No. You know when you put your hand inside, like, the gun mechanism to...
Yeah, the little handle that you squeeze.
To shoot the water out?
Right.
I didn't think I had a tight enough grip. Right. So I really lodged my hand in there, and what happened was it got caught...
So it's a pinch blister is what it is.
Yeah, absolutely. That's right.
Oh, good.
There's the remnants of it right there.
See, I wouldn't have understood how you would have been able to get a blister, you know, by sheer wearing away the skin by using, because that tool doesn't cause any stress on the hands, but if you get a little pinch blister, I guess that's how it happens.
Yeah, I got up today and I was ready to go out and power wash my blues away, and I went outside and I said, wait a minute, there's no more of that green algae stuff on our deck, and the grill is all clean. Mm-hmm. Yeah, she did it all.
The grill is the best, as far as I'm concerned. The grill used to be a job around the house that I think is the single grossest job. But that power washer, you blast away remnants of other people's food.
Well, listen, today, a big show. Many things we have to discuss on today's show.
Mm-hmm.
We should be hearing from Major Effing star Dennis Murphy here in a second.
Yeah.
Lewis will be coming in to get his ass beaten, and... Mm. I think Charlie Stossel is going to be beating his ass today.
Charlie will be doing the spanking for Lewis today for no real reason other than he's Lewis.
Oh, yeah. Well, come on. Look at him. Listen to him.
Mm-hmm.
Listen to him. He's just begging to have his ass beaten.
Did you happen to see Jerry Seinfeld on Letterman last night?
I did not.
Jerry Seinfeld, as soon as it was a promo that he was going to be on the show, I stayed up to watch it because I just wanted to see...
Dave, kiss my ass.
Oh, and it was a suck fest. It was as sucky as Dave can get with a guest. He was, you know... They were obviously two insecure guys that were trying to get one up on each other, but yet at the same time kiss each other's butts. Sure. And it was very uneasy. It made me very
queasy. What is the deal with these people in the gap between their teeth? You know, we are going to send, speaking of Lewis is going to get his ass whipped today, we got a ticket for that Sunday night show on Home BO.
Good.
So if Lewis can get up to New York City.
New York City!
Thank you, Rob. Perhaps he can shout our name out. So, and we have to also get a big paddle for Lewis.
Yes.
When I was a kid, my mom and dad used to have this big board that said Board of Education on it.
Board of Education, yes, teach you a lesson.
So today, we got to get that before he comes in, and Stossel comes in to talk about the movies, and then Stossel can give it to him and say, yeah, thank you, sir, may I have another? Yes?
Would you like a riding crop for Lewis? I have that from, remember when the domination people came in?
It's more for dominatrices.
Well, if we can't find a big paddle, perhaps we'd use the right. That'll be our fallback.
Okay, we do have that.
Always good to have a fallback.
And of course, as everyone knows, I'm a big fan of the bare hand. The bare hand, Stossel's hand to Lewis's buttocks.
All right, you bring that up with Stossel. Okay. Also, we have to do a Highway Love connection today because we have some local weekend thing to give away, a trip for a guy and a girl to a bed and breakfast. Now, you can't get me to a bed and breakfast on a bed. Mm-hmm. First off, most of them don't have air conditioning.
Right.
Second off, none of them have TV, right? And there's nothing fun to do. If you go to a bed and breakfast...
They have fireplaces, though.
How much fun can you have with a fireplace? After you throw the third book of matches in, and you watch it go up right away.
You sit there on the four-poster bed and look at the fire, the tongues of flame gently licking at the cedar lawn.
Not me, man, but somebody else maybe. So we'll give that away on today's show.
Good.
Oh, Dennis is probably on one of these lines right now. I see lots of lines ringing. Hello?
Hey, Don and Mike.
Don and Mike show. Hello.
You guys are looking too good.
Oh, you're looking too good.
How do you hear about him? You know,
they canceled his show.
Yeah, Magic's gone.
They canceled it.
So good. I'm not here anymore.
You know, we should have had some kind of a pool on when they would be canceling his show.
Yeah, well, like you called it early on, and he's gone. Before, more Magic.
I wasn't exactly Kreskin calling that.
Yeah,
as a matter of fact, Stevie Wonder said he was watching that show the first night that he thought it sucked.
He's gone now.
Oh, well, you stole my thunder. No more town crier.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Yeah, I heard that, and it was just kind of a, I don't know how I reacted, kind of a knowing smile. Just, well, we all knew it was going
to
happen.
I got bored with it. I mean, it was fun to watch for the first week because it was so bad.
It's exactly right.
But then after a while, you know, if something's really bad after a while, you go.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't want to see it anymore. I know it's going to be bad, but when it first came on,
sure.
Oh, it was like nothing else because it was so bad. It was a train wreck every night.
There has to be, to sustain viewership, you can be bad at the beginning, but to have a long-term viewership, you have to have at least some amount of entertainment value, which he had none.
And I think the moment that changed that show is when they fired the white guy.
Yes. Of course.
Well, they fired the white guy.
Because he was such a giant talent. He was so bad. He's a lot of the reason probably that it happened as quick as it did.
He was the white Uncle Tom of that show.
Yes, he was.
Right? I don't know what you call a white guy who's an Uncle Tom, a white guy who's a token.
And didn't they fire him because he was making derogatory comments about the show itself?
Yeah, he went home and watched it at night, and he said, listen, this show just sucks.
He publicly called it an embarrassment.
Well, that's tough, and it was an embarrassment. And Magic, he'll be okay. He's got plenty of money. Don't worry about Magic.
Hello there, Don and Mike show. Hello.
I hear breathing.
Hello. Julie?
Yeah.
Here she is.
I'm sorry. I was falling asleep. I'm sorry.
I just figured out who this is. This is Dennis's date from last night.
Yeah,
Julie.
I'm so worn out. I was falling asleep.
You're so worn out.
Yeah, Dennis is an animal.
Let me cut right to the chase.
Absolutely.
Did you lay him?
No, I did not lay him.
You did not lay him.
But he's an animal, huh?
Yeah. Dennis was too drunk to be laid last night.
Oh, here we go again.
Oh, boy. Oh, my. Either he's too tired or he's too drunk.
We had to drive him home last night.
Oh, really?
We had to give him a 1059 courtesy of Ocean City's Finest.
Oh, boy.
But he had a good time, huh?
Oh, he was out of control.
Oh, was it really? Where did you guys go on your day?
We started off at the Galaxy for dinner. I met Dennis at the Galaxy and started off there for dinner. And then we headed to Scandal's Nightclub at 45th Street Village.
Hey, everybody should know, of course, that this is the final day of Try to Get Dennis Murphy Laid Week.
It's been such a quick week, and I guess he wasn't successful.
It's been almost as much fun as one of Regis and Kathy Lee's Get in Shape Weeks or Makeover Week with Reg and Kathy Lee.
But in Dennis's case, he didn't get the makeover. I guess he just got a ride home. In a drunken stupor.
He did, in fact, though, meet Julie on his own, as we discovered on yesterday's episode.
Yes, he did.
Yeah. When they were dancing, when she rubbed her buttocks against his crotch.
How was your romantic dinner? I know that's a real nice restaurant you went to. How did the evening begin? Was it nice?
It was wonderful. I met Dennis there, and honest to God, I don't think he even recognized me. Really? I walked in there, he kind of looked at me, and I was like, I'm the girl from last night, but he didn't seem to know me right away.
Oh, hold on. I got Dennis on the line now. Julie, before I go to talk to him, on a scale of 1 to 10, would you please rate the date?
Absolutely. It was a 10.
A 10?
Nothing wow. short of a 10.
Would wow. you go out with him again?
We have plans in about an hour.
Oh, are you kidding me?
No,
all right,
I'm not.
New date. Oh, my God. This is a stunning upset.
Way to go.
Hold on, Julie.
Oh, man. Right,
is it possible he could close the deal by the end of the show?
We'll find out. Hey, Cary Grant.
Hello. How you doing?
Understand that you were physically unable to finish the deal last night?
I had 11 redheaded sluts.
You had too many redheaded sluts?
Yeah, I like a shooter.
Oh, those are shooters.
Yeah.
Is that the name of a shooter, the redheaded slut?
Yeah, Julie invented the glint.
Really?
Hey, what phone are you calling on? Because when you're on the phone, it sounds like, Luke, I'm your father.
I'm calling you from the Hopkinsville Hotel.
You know, Dennis, you sound a little green around the gills today.
Well, I am. You should have seen me trying to play tuck-tuck with my nieces and nephews this morning.
Wait, you went to... Hold on, I can't even understand a word you're saying. Julie?
Yes.
You went to play putt-putt with Dennis?
No, we didn't play putt-putt.
No, he said he was trying to play putt-putt with his nieces and nephews this morning.
Oh.
So, Dennis, he was trying to be Uncle Dennis.
Oh, I got you.
I guess his head was swimming a little
bit.
Yeah,
I don't think there was much of a chance of being Uncle Dennis because Uncle Dennis couldn't find his house last night.
Last night you guys went to dinner, then you went to a club.
Yes, we did.
And what happened then, Julie?
Well, as soon as we got to the club, they treat us all like major effing stars.
Wow.
Picked up our whole bar tab.
Really?
Got to thank the crew at Scandals Nightclub for treating us all like major effing stars.
Now, Dennis didn't have his major effing star shirt
no,
on, right?
No, he didn't.
You have long pants on?
Yeah, oh, God, Don and Mike, that's one thing I forgot I need to remind you about. Never tell Dennis to wear long pants and a button-up shirt.
Why?
Because I've never seen someone sweat so bad.
Who sweats more, Dennis or Mayor Barry?
Oh, I think Dennis has got Mayor Barry beat.
Yeah, Dennis can, it can be 10 below zero and Dennis can work up a pretty good sweat.
He worked up a sweat just sitting at dinner.
That's our boy.
We got him in the club and we started dancing. He was out of control.
Really? Did it look seriously like he was in the dunking booth when he got done doing that?
Yes, it did. Besides for the sweat, he had redheaded slut stains all over the front of his shirt.
The shooters where they were just flying everywhere.
Yeah,
huh?
It was. We just kept ordering more and more and more and more.
Julie,
Dennis was out of control.
Let me ask you, was there any romance? Is there any romance?
Oh, there's definitely romance.
Oh, are you kidding?
Oh, no, not at all.
Are you like an escaped mental patient or something?
No, not yet.
All right,
not yet.
Then do me a favor, and what is the attraction? Seriously, if you could enlighten us.
What is he seeing me or I seeing him?
Yeah, what do you see in Dennis? You know, I know we all...
We know what we see in Dennis.
We all know what a study looks like, but other than that, where is the attraction? What about his personality do you like so much?
Yeah. The fact that every 5 minutes he says, "Did I tell you how beautiful you were?"
Oh,
no man has ever said
he's a
like
romantic.
That to me.
Yeah,
he's sweet.
Oh, he's definitely he's got a way with words.
Be sweet. Hey, Buzz.
Yes.
Speaking of love, one of the things I wanted to ask you about Monica.
Yeah.
Did she say that she loves Clinton? Didn't I?
I hadn't read that last night.
I got home and I watched CNN. You know,
right?
What's the point of having these secret proceedings?
Yeah, if we don't know what's going on.
But you do. Because they're having secret testimony and they say,
right.
CNN has learned.
Mm-hmm.
And one of the things I heard is that she said that they had sex in the Oval Office at least 12 times.
Right.
Uh-huh. Not just BJ's, real sex.
Oh, really?
That she was in love with him. Right?
Wow.
And then this morning on CNN, they said we have an unsubstantiated report that she had an abortion.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, right.
Wow.
Now, they're announcing this. Listen, this is how hypocritical CNN is. They got the thing at the bottom of the screen that says breaking news, right?
Right.
And they got the guy in the front of the White House. But the breaking news is that, well, they heard a rumor that might be true, that she might have had an abortion at some time.
Has anything come across the wire about that, Buzz?
No, there's been nothing on the Associated Press or anything like that about
well,
that.
Well, turn on CNN.
All right.
You got a TV there, right?
Yeah, I do.
Okay.
Did she say that she loved him? Has that been reported? Well, I heard it on CNN. What am I asking him for? Yeah. I heard them say on CNN that she said that she had loved him.
Wow. It doesn't surprise me because she followed him around so much. There was obviously that kind of infatuation there, especially since other people had been instructed to keep her away from him at certain public functions.
That is a mind blower if that that's what's leaked out of her testimony.
Oh, boy.
Leaked out of her testimony.
Leaked out and left a little stain. Left a little stain the FBI would look at.
God, so they really did it, and she may have had an abortion?
Yeah, now both of those things are alleged from,
because there's nothing
yet. Leaks.
High-level sources close to the investigation, right, which seems to be the nice way of saying it.
All right, we'll get back to that. I just wanted to ask you that, and I remembered about that, Buzz. Now, Julie?
Yes?
Julie, did you wear a blue cocktail dress last night?
No, I wore a black dress.
That voice sounds a little rough today, Julie. You had a rough night, huh?
Oh, it was rough.
Are you going to save the dress and give it to your mother?
So when do you get your twin involved in this?
Oh, she was there last night.
She was?
Oh, she was.
Oh, yeah. She was on fire last night, too.
Now, is she attracted to Dennis as you are?
Oh, absolutely.
Well, she is.
She nicknamed him Denisto, her man, Denisto. I think at one point she might have wanted him more than I did.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
But you do want him?
Oh, absolutely.
Are you guys identical twins?
Hmm?
Or are you identical twins or maternal twins?
Identical.
And what are you doing with Dennis today?
Today we're going to go hang gliding. We're taking Dennis hang gliding, courtesy of the Fly Tech Boys in Fenwick Island, Delaware.
You are kidding.
Oh, my God.
Wow.
Oh, my God.
You're taking Dennis hang gliding?
Yes, we are.
Oh. Ladies and gentlemen, this may be the last report from Dennis Murphy on the show.
Well, hold on, Julie. Hold on a second.
This gets better. This gets better and better.
Hey, Ben.
Yes.
He's super stud.
Hey.
Last night, redhead sluts all over your shirt. You're sweating like a banshee. You have two twin sisters dancing with you.
I was in the middle of a sandwich.
And they're taking you hang gliding today.
Yeah.
In the middle of a sister sandwich.
I look at the Oreo cookie.
Man, oh man.
I can't believe this.
She looks like Jodie Foster.
Jodie Foster, you know, and a little cracky eye in her face.
You know, Dennis, I asked her, what do you like most about Dennis? And she said that, you kept saying you're so beautiful. So keep up the romantic talk. It's working for you.
You know what? You know, I kept on saying to her yesterday, am I in a fantasy right now?
Yeah. You're a smooth talker. Let me conference these lines together. Hello. Hey, Julie. Here he is.
Hi, Dennis.
Hey, Julie. How you doing?
I'm wonderful. How are you?
Are you hungover?
Oh, no. I feel great.
Yeah.
A few minutes to get going this morning, but now that I'm going, you can't stop me.
Oh, that's good. Julie, I would like to thank you for last night. You are unbelievable.
Unbelievable.
Oh, Dennis, it was all my pleasure.
Yeah.
I was just lucky to be there.
I can't believe. Kill me.
And Dennis, have you ever been hang gliding before?
No, I haven't. I'm just going to watch. I'm not going to do it.
Are you going to stay on the ground?
Yeah.
Probably just as well.
I don't want to leave you, Mike.
Yeah, I know, Dennis. I don't want you to ever leave me.
Stay with him forever, Dennis.
Stay with me, Dennis.
Okay, so listen.
For you, I will.
After you guys are done with the hang gliding this afternoon, will you be discoing it tonight?
Oh, absolutely. I'm going to take you out and show you a better time than I showed you last night.
Oh, listen to this. Dennis Murphy has a girlfriend. Dennis has a girlfriend.
Hey, God, Mike.
Yes, Dan.
He has already agreed to meet me on the secret.
Oh, for our Las Vegas show.
That's great. We'll get a chance to meet you, Julie.
Oh, it's going
to
be my pleasure.
And she said I'm going to spend the night that night.
She said that you could what?
Spend the night at her place.
Listen,
jeez.
Stud.
Dennis, this is just too good to be true.
I know. I'm still in a fantasy world. Is this a fantasy or is this real?
Are you like me, Mike? Are you waiting for the other shoe to drop?
I sure am.
Are you waiting? All right, listen, here's all I want to say to you. The crying game.
Oh, no.
Julie, you're not, or have you ever been a man?
No, I never have, and I don't think I'm ever going to be.
Julie, do you have a penis?
No, I do not.
Okay, so far, that's one. That's one shoe that's not going to drop.
Nope. No surprises. What you see is what you get.
Are you one of those women that stalks men and then kills them and shoves them down open manhole covers?
Not yet.
Really?
Not yet.
You're just
I'm a nice girl.
You're crazy in love with Dennis Murphy.
Absolutely.
Well, go figure that. Hey, everybody, it doesn't look like he's going to get laid this week on the show, but Dennis Murphy. Oh, that's so annoying hearing that echo. Hold on.
That's terrible.
Oh, God. And that's just on Dennis's line, right?
Mrs. Julie Murphy.
Yes.
Wow. There she is. Well, listen, Julie, you make sure that you show Dennis a good time.
Oh, I'll show him more than a good time.
Wow.
Really?
Absolutely.
Well, that's the second day in a row you've talked like that, Julie. And
well, if Dennis hadn't gotten himself in so much trouble with the redheaded slut last night, he could have had me.
Oh, my God.
Wait, now that's just
right there. Turn off the music, please.
That is an offer for Dennis. That's incredible.
Hold on. I got to go talk to him. Hold on a second. Hold on. Did you hear that?
Yeah, I heard it. I heard it.
Don't you have one thing to drink tonight?
No,
don't eat anything. Don't drink anything.
And for God's sakes, don't touch yourself.
And take a shower.
I'm going to take a shower right now.
Take two.
Okay, two. I just got swimming. Oh, God, my car's going crazy. Okay. I'm calling for my car.
What's going crazy?
His car's going crazy.
The window. The car window going up and down. I can't control it. Okay.
That's not the only thing going up and down you can't control. Jesus, listen to him.
Oh, he's in heaven. Dennis, is this the best vacation you've ever had?
Oh, man, my goodness. Oh, God, unbelievable. I can't believe it.
Unbelievable. All right, Dennis, please, if you get a chance during the show today, call us and let us know how the hang gliding goes.
Okay.
All right, and obviously on Monday, I guess, we'll need to hear everything.
You will hear everything.
All right, thank you, Dan.
Hey, Julie, is Julie
calling? Yeah, all right, hold on. Here she is. Here's Dennis, Julie.
Hi, Dennis.
Hi, Julie. Are you at home? Can I call you?
I'm at home. You can call me. I'll be waiting for you.
Okay.
All right, call me later.
I will call you in 2 seconds.
Hey, Dennis, why don't you call her and have phone sex? Hey, you know who just walked in?
Who is that that's stumbling by the window there?
That was Jimmy Babbitt.
Jimmy Babbitt came by.
Jimmy Babbitt in the house.
Wow.
All right, Dennis, we'll see you later. And goodbye, Julie. Be nice to him now.
I'm always nice.
All right. Julie?
Yes.
Caught with you in 2 seconds.
Okay, honey.
Bye.
All right,
bye.
Bye.
Wow.
Well, go figure.
You know, last night at dinner, I mean, I found myself talking about Dennis Murphy even after the show was over.
Maybe she's doing it just to get close to us.
You think so?
You ever think that?
Yeah, well, you know, if she
not
is...
Not that I think that we're too self-important or anything.
we're not like Jerry Seinfeld. But I'll tell you something, it does have that too-good-to-be-true quality to it, but hey, you know, why knock it when it's happening? I mean, he's obviously had a great time last night, he's going to have a great time tonight, and we'll find out about it on Monday.
Mike, our little boy has become a man.
Oh, man, wow. It's kind of like we're going to lose him, Don.
It's fine with me. See you later. Now, listen, what's Jimmy Babbitt doing here?
You want him?
Yeah, sure, I guess. Well, why else did he come by the station today? Jimmy Babbitt, of course, married Michelle.
Yep, newlyweds.
Today, as a matter of fact, is their two-week anniversary.
They've been married 2 weeks, and Jimmy Babbitt just dropped by. We're going to have to see what he wants.
I don't know what he's doing here. Oh, and as long as we're on the topic of love and such, you know, we do have this bed and breakfast thing to give away, so let's set up a highway love connection. Now, you have to be in the D.C. or Baltimore or Pennsylvania area.
Very good.
To qualify for this, and we're going to ask you girls, hey, Jimmy Babbitt.
Jimmy Babbitt's here.
We're going to ask you girls to go to a payphone right now and call us up at 1-800-636-1067. And announce your location, and then we'll get a guy to come by and meet you, and you get a getaway for two to the Blue Rock Inn in Paris, Virginia.
That's beautiful country out there.
No TVs, though. So bring your watchman or something.
Mm-hmm.
And now here's the blushing husband, Jimmy Babbitt. Hey, Jimmy Babbitt.
Definitely blushing. Hello,
hey,
guys.
Jimmy.
Hi, good to see you again, Jim.
Can I sit?
Oh, yeah, please have a seat.
Yes, absolutely.
Thank you.
Happy anniversary, Jim. Well, today is my anniversary. It's my 17th, and today is your two-week anniversary.
You know, and I was thinking on the way over here that much like my first marriage, this is no sex in this one either.
Hey, you know what? Now that I'm thinking about it, hey, Jimmy, how would you like to go on this weekend getaway to a bed and breakfast if we could find you a chick?
You've been too kind already, guys.
All right, he don't want to go for some reason.
All right, I got it. No, I know. I understand.
Hey, we'll be cool with you on that. Don't worry. Right.
Yeah, no pressure.
Way too much already for me.
No pressure. You're really a nice guy, and you know.
Did you see what I brought? The girls in a camp. My owner had this blown up. They wanted to have it autographed. They have it hanging in the accounting office.
But Jimmy's got some gigantic.
Oh.
It is a giant wall-sized picture of Jimmy Babbitt on his wedding night being put into the ambulance after they thought he had died. That
is the funniest thing I've ever
That seen. Is effing funny, Jimmy.
And the guys down at work did this?
The owner did.
The owner did?
Yes, yeah, he thought it was quite hilarious.
Look at that. That's big wall size. And take a look at Jimmy Babbitt's face in that picture.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. Look at him.
Oh, look at that. I didn't know.
IVs in both arms.
The paramedic supporting your...
look at this.
Hey, pass that over.
Down there, man.
How big is this thing? This is like 3 feet
easily
by...
30 inches by 24 inches. Or
look at that. Advanced life support unit. Oh, no. It's the ambulance in front of the restaurant, and there's a couple of people taking him out on the gurney. And look at Jimmy's face. Look at him.
When did they present that with you, Jimmy?
They sprung that on me 2 or 3 days ago.
Oh, no.
Yeah, called everybody into the accounting office, and they were all laughing at me. I couldn't figure out why, and this was hanging on the wall.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, you do have some good friends there. Well, I don't know, you know, if they're good friends, but you do. You have
good sense of humor.
Yeah, right. They have a good sense of humor.
Oh, man.
God damn, that's funny.
Okay, and there it is. There's your wedding day memento, right? That you can always, are you going to put that in a place of honor down at work?
I believe they're going to just leave it in the accounting office just for as long as I'm there.
Now, Jimmy, have you talked to your wife at all this week? We like finding out if you two are talking.
Once or twice.
Maybe
2 or 3 times, yeah.
Without getting too deep into detail, how are things going?
Well, fine.
All right, well, that's not very in detail. Well, thank you.
Fine as in...
All right, I asked her to move in with me.
You did?
Yes, I did.
And?
Wow.
She's thinking about it.
Are you kidding? Seriously? Really asked her that?
Seriously.
So the conversations have actually gone quite well.
Absolutely.
Well, that would be a bombshell. That's the cotton picking bomb.
Where's the bomb sound effect?
That would be a cotton picking bomb if she actually moved in with you, Jimmy.
I would say it's at our last conversation. It's 75 or 80% close.
Oh my God! This is a huge development.
You know, wait a minute, hold on. Somebody stop me. Dennis Murphy has met a woman that wants to go out with him. Jimmy Babbitt has asked Michelle, his wife, to move in with him.
This is a wonderful development.
Hi, Michelle.
How did this happen? Obviously, you guys must have had some great conversations.
We just got along okay.
And she got to know you a little better with the phone conversation.
Who wouldn't love me?
Hell, I love you. Don and Mike.
Hey, Don. What's going on?
Baldy.
Hey, I was wondering what you thought about Jay Leno wrestling tomorrow night.
You want to know something? I'm going to order that pay-per-view to see Jay Leno wrestle tomorrow night.
He's been doing the trash talk. I've watched a lot of him, and he doesn't do it as a bit. When I first saw him do that trash talk, I thought, you know, one of these screens would be in back of him, and Hulk Hogan would rip through it. But no,
He's
just been continuously trash talking.
Pretty cool. Yeah, yeah. No, I'm thinking about buying it tomorrow night.
Yeah, they've been messing with him a pretty good bit on wrestling, but I've watched Jay Leno, and
we're going to see his skin.
They keep talking back and forth.
Will we see Leno's skin?
I hope Jay Leno has to wear one of those outfits like Buzz is wearing now. No offense, Buzz. But you know the one-piece, like, male leotard thing?
Yeah, I'm wearing real clothes now, by the way.
Are you really?
Bulletin. Are you wearing a blue cotton cocktail dress?
No, just regular, you know, like a golf shirt and...
Attention.
Very loose shorts.
Attention. Buzz is clothed.
Yeah, I want to see that.
I'm very proud of that.
I mean, not Buzz. Of course I want to see Buzz. When are you coming back to work, Buzz?
I don't know. I hope to find out Monday when I go see the doctor.
I'd like to see Jay Leno in the standard wrestler's pants. You know, those tight pants, and then, of course, no shirt.
Oh, this is Jay Leno. All right. Here I am with my pink nipples getting ready to wrestle Hulk Hogan.
How fat is Jay Leno?
He's fat enough, you know. He's fat enough. Covers it up, though, with a very, a nice series of,
Brother. No. Hey, brother, I'm going to rip that jaw, brother.
Oh, that's not true. I'm going to, twist you down into the mat. That's what I'm going to do, yeah.
Hey, brother.
So this is Jay Leno. Get ready to wrestle.
Hello, it's Don and Mike Show.
Tough guy. I'm Jay Leno, a very tough guy. You know, I work on cars. That's what I do. I'm a tough grease monkey guy.
Hello.
Please watch The End of the Wild Bunch in slow-mo.
The Wild Bunch? What's that? What movie's that?
1969, Sam Peckinpah.
All right.
Real bloody, right?
Yeah, and the whole ending is in slow-mo, so if you watch it in slow-mo, it'll be a trip.
Yeah, but you know, it's fake. You know, it's not like some of the stuff we've been watching.
Not like Private Ryan.
Schindler's Fist.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Goodbye.
All right, I guess he wasn't calling for a love. He was calling about a movie made in 1969.
We got a million goofy guys calling us right now, so we'll do a break. And if you girls want this trip, call us. And if not, the Spiewax will have a beautiful weekend at the bed and breakfast. No, we'll find a girl when we come right back.
This
feeling that you're gay.
They have more than enough hair down there. Don and Mike.
Hey, Buzz?
Yes, yes, Don.
You're wearing clothes again, Buzzy. You're wearing regular pants.
All right.
Buzz Burbank. No more Simmons leotard.
Does it feel good to be in real clothes, Buzz?
Well, the pants are very, very loose. They can hardly be called real pants, but I'm getting there.
Do they have a stretch waistband?
Extremely stretch.
Oh, wonderful.
Yeah, baby.
So you're wearing kind of a sweatsuit ensemble today?
No, it's just it's a golf shirt and shorts, but the shorts are very, very loose.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, baby. Now, are you wearing underpants?
No.
Well, some things never change, huh,
that's
Buzz?
That's right.
That'll
that's
never change right. for Buzz.
Hello? No.
Hello?
Don and Mike Show. Where are the girls?
He could be like that guy on Friends. Remember that episode of Friends when the guy was sitting there and he would put his leg up and he wasn't wearing underwear underneath his big gym shorts and the guys would all go, oh, God.
Hello?
Hi, Don and Mike.
Yes.
It is Pam, your backup bride.
Hey, Pam, the backup. Oh, you're the lady that showed up to get married in case Jimmy Babbitt's bride backed out?
I know. I am.
Hello, beautiful.
All right, hold on a second there.
What?
I'm just being Rudy.
That's Rudy's new catchphrase. Don't you know that he always says, guess what?
Yes. So I need an update. I hate to treat this like a news show, but what happened with Julie and Dennis last night?
Oh, listen.
The car.
Oh. Listen, Mr. Lazy Listener.
Lazy listening.
No. Easy. Listen, this is such big news. I think you got to do the half an hour update.
No. You have to listen to the whole show. We had Cary Grant on for the whole first break today.
Yeah, plus you got that cell phone with maple syrup in it that doesn't help much either.
Listen, he did okay. He went out dancing with a girl, and we think that she would have laid him last night, except he was too drunk.
Oh, no way.
No way.
You have to listen better.
Thank you. Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Hi, when are you guys going to do the credit card game?
Oh, we haven't even done that today.
Oh, my God, that's right.
Oh, we had all this other crap to do.
Yeah, we got
to
give away, at some point we're giving away $5,000.
Well, I guess now. All right, how you like that? Guess what?
Yeah.
No, how about this?
Guess what?
I'm
the 100th caller.
No.
Yes.
No, but we'll take all 100 right now.
Oh, come on. Now we've got to try all over again.
Bye. 1-800-636-1067.
Caller.
Caller 100. We'll give you something made of plastic and qualify you for the $5,000 giveaway. That is on Wednesday, June 26th.
August 26th.
What?
I'm sorry, August 26th.
Yeah, that's right. That's all right.
Call back.
All right.
I'm sure you'll get through.
Okay.
All right. Listen, Chuck Stossel's going to come on the show in a second. Oh, he's already here. Hey, Chuck.
Hey, guys. Charlie told me to come in.
Hey, how do you feel about paddling Lewis?
You hate Lewis as much as we do, right?
He's the most annoying guy I've ever met. You know, after 10 seconds, he annoys the hell out of you.
Hi, Charlie.
Hello. He just arrived.
We had Lewis on the show yesterday, and at one point, I just said to him, oh, I would love to just beat your ass. Mm-hmm. And then Mike said, hey, it would be fun to beat Lewis's ass.
Yeah, I mean, of all the men that I've come in contact with in the last 6 months or so, Lewis would be at the top of the hit parade as far as, wanting to perform physical violence.
Yeah, but Lewis, it's almost feeble. It's like hitting a girl.
Yeah, well, that's why, this evolved.
That's why you'd be perfect for
him. And this evolved into spanking, I mean, I think it's gone from beating.
I think I'd hurt him. I really think.
Good.
Listen,
how about you go first, and then we'll all go. We have a writing crop that we're going to be beating his ass with today.
Oh, Rob has to go first. Somebody else other than me, because I have to see how hard to hit. I'd hurt the guy. I'd drop blood.
All right, I'll go first.
You're going to go first?
Yeah, okay. I hate him enough to do it.
All right. I'm there. Take a shot.
That'll just be kind of a warm-up for his trip to the fetish club. I'm pretty sure that Homo Joe is taking him out either to a leather club or to a fetish club tonight.
Do I have to use the riding crop or can I use my fist? No, I'm just kidding.
We should hear the report on Monday. Okay, well, listen, before you talk about movies,
sure.
Let's get the very annoying Lewis in here.
All right, here we go.
Oh, plus we got to ask him if he's ready to take that bus trip up to New York.
New York City!
Thank you, Rob, because we finally got the ticket for the Jerry Seinfeld show on Home B.O.
This is a very important assignment for Lewis.
And he could stand up and scream out our name. Where's he at?
Where's Lewis? You know, he's probably next to Christine. That's what he does whenever he comes into the building.
He might love Christine more than you do, Charlie.
Really? Oh, there he is. He's coming down the hallway now.
Someone by the window.
Here he is.
Lewis has just arrived. He was in the far reaches of the building.
Hey, Lou. Hey, Lutard.
Here he comes.
Come on in. God, look at him.
Nice to see you, man.
Hi. You are so butt annoying. I swear to God.
How's it going?
All right. Are you ready for your big weekend?
Yeah, what's going to happen?
Okay, first off, you're going out with Homo Joe tonight. Did you know that?
Fabulous.
You're going either to a fetish club or to a leather club.
Don't ever, ever.
Oh,
that,
sorry.
That, I
sorry,
swear
Mike.
To God.
Why, what did he do? What did he do? What did
he
do?
He touched me.
He touched me.
Shoes.
He touched me. I don't care. Shoes are part of the body. Don't ever touch me again, Lewis.
Look at him.
This is great. I love radio stuff.
He is jumping around. He is spazzed out of
yes!
his mind.
I love you guys like family. I'm serious. And I know that sounds stupid, but really it's the truth. I'd like
shut up, Lewis.
Tongue kiss you all.
Stop it.
Listen.
Shut up.
So tonight you're going out with Homo Joe. Then we're going to get you a bus ticket. We're going to try to get you up to New York City to go to the Jerry Seinfeld show.
You guys are the men. Yes. Yes.
Now listen, if we get you all the way up there for that live show, you have to pick the right moment in the live Home B.O. broadcast to jump up and scream Jerry Seinfeld. Now, should he
you
say...
You know what he should do? I was thinking about this. He should do it like Grippy did it. Don and Mike, Jerry. You know how... Remember when Grippy went, Don and Mike, Whitney? And he should just go, Don and Mike, Jerry.
How simply about Don it? And Mike, Jerry.
Yes.
Let me hear you try that
get
one time.
Town,
go back to go into the
try
back
it
of the room and try it at the top of your lungs.
Now, let's say Jerry's doing his jokes. Cottage cheese? People don't live in cottages.
Laugh, laugh, laugh.
Don and Mike, Jerry!
Now, don't Lewisize it.
See, the more he practices, the more it makes you want to beat his ass, doesn't it? All right, now, here we go. Cottage cheese, who are these people? Ha, ha, ha.
Don and Mike, Jerry.
Louder, Lewis.
Got to be loud. You ought to play him the Whitney tape it's going to be a big crowd.
Right, listen, here you go. Listen to this.
This is the way Rob Grippy did it, Lewis. Lewis.
This is Rob Grippy with Whitney Houston.
Shadow box.
Pay attention, Lewis.
Listen, Lewis. Listen up now.
Hey, how y'all doing? Oh, I'm real nervous now. All my friends are here. Oh, God. Huh? Ooh, yeah.
Do you hear that?
Whatever you say.
Hear how loud Rob Grippy was?
Absolutely. Can you project that much with your little 98-pound right weakling body?
Try again. Who are these people? Ha, ha, ha.
Don and Mike, Jerry!
Better. Better. You know, in some ways, I hope he doesn't take this as a compliment.
Yes.
But... don't you think he kind of looks like a young and maybe slightly retarded Jim Carrey?
Yeah, he's got a little Jim Carrey in him.
As you look at him.
How do you mean retarded?
He's got a little Jim Carrey in him
forehead
right there.
All right. Where do we get this riding crop from?
Jerk!
What do we have? We have both a metal stick. I don't know. Why'd they bring me in a metal stick?
Don't put the metal stick on. I mean, there are certain limits to everything.
I don't
here
want to beat him with a metal
Rob,
stick.
Rob, did you bring in the metal stick?
No, well, I think Broyhill did. Broyhill did.
Yeah,
however,
Rob would love to use the metal stick on
this. This is the riding crop.
Okay. Oh, there it is.
Hey, hey!
All right. Oh man, that is
that's
nasty.
That's gonna hurt.
Yeah.
How do people get into that?
All right, Lewis. Come on over here and bend over, please.
Hold on. This is so homo. You know that, don't you?
It is. I know
hey,
that
maybe
I think
Christine
about
would like to come grab some
hey,
butt.
Stop it.
Well, I mean, it's a girl. I mean, you guys.
You know what?
Guys,
I bet she hates you enough to want to beat your ass,
maybe
too.
She'd like to grab some butt. Let's see what happens. Why not? Please.
All right. All right, let's ask Christine in and see if Christine would like be the first to beat your ass.
I fear we were just manipulated by Lewis. That makes me feel very uncomfortable.
No, I think Christine could probably work off some of that anti-Lewis...
Mm-hmm.
feeling that she has. Hey, Christine.
Christine, would you like to beat Lewis with a riding crop?
Look how fast she's going for it. Yeah, she'd like to beat his ass.
All right.
Hey, now, Christine, come here for a minute.
Some guys might consider this a privilege.
Now, don't make this good for him, okay?
I won't.
Okay, real hard. Now, look at how hard. Look, watch. Stand back now.
She looks enthusiastic about this.
Like that hard, okay?
Can Christine go next?
All right, and she's going to go first.
She's right. First. All right, now
can
bend
I
over.
Go next?
She may be first and last.
Yeah, we may let her take all our turns.
Bend over, Lewis.
All right, let's see.
She is so anxious to do this.
Hold on, let's get Lewis over here by my microphone. Lewis,
all right,
get over here.
Come on over here.
We'll get him right here.
All right, Lewis.
Bend over. Now, you are so annoying. Bend over. And right. When she smacks you, say, thank you, sir. May I have another? What, Christine?
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. All right, sorry. Thank you, ma'am. May I have another?
All right, here we go.
All right, Lewis.
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 Oh,
stop it. Pay attention. Sorry. Bend over.
All right.
Bend over.
It looks like he's taking a dump.
Oh, she did smack his ass.
Do it again. Again.
Thank you. Again. Mistress, may I have... Oh, thank you. This
two
is
hands,
so
Christine.
Un-Homo.
All right, yeah, two hands, please. Two hands, Christine.
How about bare hands?
Two hands.
All right.
Come on, really beat his
come
ass,
on,
Christine.
Right,
there you go.
Here we go.
Up to bat.
Here we
come
go.
On, Lewis. Lewis, bend over.
Oh,
you can hit harder than that.
Yeah, baby. Oh, yeah, baby. One more, come on, get
it. Oh. That one was a little tough. That one, she did that one like a man.
All right, way to go. Hey, a round of applause for Christine.
Very nice, Christine.
Nicely done.
How happy she was to beat your ass.
Oh, she enjoyed that thoroughly.
Oh, that was good.
And unfortunately, in a sick way, Lewis got pleasure out of it, too.
Yeah? She didn't hit you as hard as I'm going to hit you.
If you get to hit me, I'm hitting you next time.
Oh!
Oh.
There's a threat.
Oh, you think so, tough guy?
That's only fair, right?
Yeah, right. Your position on this show, as you know, is not fair.
You're right. I'm the intern. What
That's
am I saying?
Right.
I'm delusional. Saying,
you're
hey,
not
Lewis.
Even, you know, it doesn't even count as an intern, Lewis. You are more like Danger Boy. You are somebody who we send out to do these insane things. You don't have any rights on the program.
I really do appreciate what I get to do.
Just thought I'd clear it up for you.
All right, well, listen, I'll just give you one.
Okay?
Just one.
Can I get on the left bum because I'm a little swollen on the right, guys?
All right, get him on the left,
sure.
On
right,
the left one.
Come over here, piss boy.
All right, give him one.
Bend over.
All right, Lewis.
Now, which
Homo?
One? Which one? Did you call me a homo?
No.
Bend
no,
over.
Oh, no.
Right. I'll show you a homo.
Here we go.
Bend
one
over.
Good one.
Come on, bend over. Bend
ready?
Over.
Wait. Let's do it. Oh, wait. Let's do one on the count of three. Ready?
I missed his butt. I got him on the leg.
Lewis, all right, turn around. Here we go. One,
two,
three.
Hey, now!
You want to try, Mike?
Yes, I would. I'd like
all
to
right,
try.
All right, Lewis. Now let Mike, please.
Very much.
Come on, Mike. Suddenly, you know, when I gave Lewis a little smack, it became not so much fun, huh?
No, actually it was because you got me directly on the bung.
All right. Lewis, I can't get any real leverage from this point, so step down off there.
Bend right. Over, please,
no,
Lewis.
Down there, Lewis, on the lower level.
If you're just tuning in, we're beating Lewis's ass because he's so annoying.
All right.
Come on, Lewis.
Hold on. Let me see what you
put. All right, Mike's going to practice a little bit.
Yeah.
Hey, that's good.
That sound good?
That's
all right.
Good.
All right, here we go. Don't look at me.
Don't look. Never look at Mike when he's spanking you.
Okay, ready? One,
two, three.
There you go.
Oh, he fell down.
Sure. That was way too hard, man.
All right, one last person. Charlie Stossel?
He was
Homo?
Carrie. He was Jim Carrey-esque when he said, that was way too hard, man.
Okay, one more now.
All right.
One more, Lewis.
Yeah. You like this, don't you?
Fight me.
No, you really
oh, here
I
you
can
go.
Tell by the socks. Here
oh,
you go.
Now we got a battle.
He's
going.
Really challenging.
Oh, Charlie's lucky. He's wearing a baseball bat.
You all guys right. Are so lucky. I don't get to do this. I swear to God, I'd
okay,
have no
right.
Mercy.
Turn around. Turn around.
Very nice, Lewis. Lewis,
right,
very
Lewis,
nice.
We give you a round of applause.
Very nice.
You took your medicine like a man.
Very nice.
Nice job. Are those your sunglasses, Lewis? Put those on. Let me see you with those sunglasses on. This adds to the entire
what kind of sunglasses does he have?
Take a look at these sunglasses.
Like Ray-Bans or what?
They are.
The retarded sunglasses.
Oh, God. He is in rare Lewis form today.
Jesus Can I
Christ.
Show you guys something?
What?
Let
what?
Me just go grab it. It's real quick. You
all
guys
right.
Talk amongst yourselves. I'll be right back.
All right.
All right. Go grab it.
Listen, I got to tell you something. He's the nuttiest one we've ever had.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. Now, let's not go so far as say he's good. He's not really
good. No, I
good.
Just said he's the nuttiest one we've ever had.
God, or something. Lewis has a good energy happening today.
Yes.
He truly does.
It was fun to beat his ass, wasn't it?
All right, he's bringing something into show.
What is this?
Because when you're a homo, it's fun to beat another guy's ass.
All right.
Okay, this picture right here is the first time you guys ever let me come on in 1992. And, Mike, you took that picture, and you did a very good job, and I keep it on my wall. And
you
I
remember the story of Lewis is that, like, 6 years ago, he was a baby DJ. He wanted to be on the radio, and he actually... actually came down here one day. Let me see the picture.
That is amazing. Now, you know,
great. Thank you.
Thank God I don't remember.
Oh,
that.
My God. How old were you in this picture, Lewis?
10th grade, about 15, 16, 15, wow. I think, because I look like I'm 9. So
now,
that's
did you
better.
Still, did you have that rap? Had you developed this persona at that point in your career?
Not. In front of people. I could do it in front of friends. I was, you know, personal acquaintances.
So you were
but,
just a nice kid, right, when you came by? You
oh,
were,
no, I was a big jerk-off.
You really were?
A little big jerk-off with braces.
All right. That's a nice picture, Lewis. Have a good time tonight with Homo Joe.
So it's on because there's rumors that it's not going to happen.
Oh, really?
Well, if that doesn't happen, you're definitely going to New York.
New York City!
All right, either way, have a good time at both of those functions.
Okay.
And we'll see you next week.
I'll get out of here.
All right, good.
Bye, Lewis.
Good idea. There he is. Craig Coleman, everybody. Yeah.
Craig Coulthard.
The Lutard.
God.
Oh. Nobody tell him. I think he's a pretty good guy to let us beat him. All right? I mean, I don't want him to get a big head or anything, but... He's a pretty good guy.
Man, way to step up to the plate, Christine.
Oh, yeah. Christine, obviously. You know what that is? That's weeks and weeks of yes. Lewis hitting on her.
Mm-hmm.
And she finally got to hit back.
Absolutely. I love
All
it.
All right. A break. Chuck Stossel, who got into it once everybody started beating Lewis's ass. It was fun, wasn't it, Charlie?
It was just fine.
All right. We'll talk movies with Charlie when we come right back.
This is the Don and Mike Show.
The Don and Mike Show on 98.1 The Peak.
It's the biggest breakthrough in getting a good night's sleep. Good Morning America, Dateline NBC, and the Wall Street Journal ran features on it. What is it? It's the Tempur-Pedic Swedish mattress, an innovation so effective over 25,000 doctors, chiropractors, and sleep clinics recommend it. Now you can get a free sample of the incredible material behind this mattress and a free better sleep video. Call toll-free 1-888-810-1133. The Tempur-Pedic Swedish mattress contours to every curve of your body. It relieves the pressure that makes you toss and turn. In fact, tests show that Tempur-Pedic users toss and turn 83% less, so you sleep sounder. For people with back or neck problems, Tempur-Pedic offers unprecedented relief. For a free sample of this sleep-enhancing material, call 1-888-810-1133. Call now and you'll also get Tempur-Pedic's Better Sleep Video absolutely free. Feel for yourself what all the excitement is about. Call Tempur-Pedic now. That's 1-888-810-1133.
It's happening all across America. Phones are ringing all across America. People are no longer saying talk is cheap. They're saying talk is free. To what do we owe this telephonic phenomenon? The newest toll-free dialing code 877. Yes, 877. It's toll-free like 800 and 888 numbers. And it's carefree like 800 and 888 numbers. But it's new. So remember, talk is free with toll-free dialing code 877. This message brought to you by SMS 800.
Jumping out in front is Sam with his project on Irish castles. Coming up fast is Marley with hers on iguanas. But from the outside, it's Eduardo with a multimedia Mayan mathematics report.
Now more kids can go to the head of the class because Radio Shack has the new Compact Creative Learning Series with software and internet enhancements. Compact home computers that can help kids do better in school so they'll do better in life. From only $9.99, only at Radio Shack. Monitor not included.
And out of nowhere, it's Ian.
98.1. The Peak is WPEK, Seneca, Greenville, Spartanburg, and...
Ask and talk movies with Charlie Stossel.
Right.
Totally forgot about our caller 100.
Oh, boy!
So let's do that right now.
Married, twice shy, here's movie man Charlie Stossel.
Ah, You always take that delicate little sip of your beverage before you start your report. You ever notice that?
Delicate little sip.
We work with a guy for a while. You get
take
to
a manly
his,
swig.
Yeah, why do you need the straw? Why don't you just take a regular swig.
There you go. Good man. That's right. Get some of that ice in your mouth. Chew up the ice, Charlie.
Oh, God. There you go.
My teeth are way too sensitive to chew ice.
Oh, I hate that. I hate that. You know, they say chewing ice is a sign of sexual frustration.
Oh, man.
Oh, really?
Well, do I go through some blocks on the weekend?
Well, listen, Lewis is, as it turns out, going to New York. He's going to drive himself. We're not going to send him on a bus.
Good.
Got the ticket, and his assignment will be to scream out our names at some point during the live Jerry Seinfeld show on Sunday night, and we'll have the recap on that on Monday's episode.
So if anybody sees the Wienermobile out on I-95, you'll know that Lutard's on the way.
But now let's talk movies with our man Chuck Stossel from the AMC chain. Mother Chucker, what is new this weekend?
Oh, summer's over, boys and girls. Halloween, H2O.
Hermaphrodite. What? Jamie Lee Curtis.
Yes.
Genitals of both man and woman.
Any nudity? Any nudity right off the bat? Any nudity from her?
Not from Jamie, no.
Her incredible tatas?
No, at this point in her career, I don't think she needs to rely on showing her big, beautiful breasts.
And is it called H2O because Mike Myers makes water?
No, I believe it's like T2, Halloween, 20 years later. I think that's what the H2O. Oh.
You know, that's a movie, the original Halloween. I think it was last Halloween that Frieda and I had been spending a couple of weeks building Bart up about this movie.
Right.
Saying there was a movie that we saw that was so scary, and we rented it. We had the Blockbuster rented it. We watched it, and it sucks 20 years later.
Exactly. Compared to some of the stuff like Scream,
I Know What You Did Last Summer. Yeah.
Halloween, though, a trailblazer, if I'm not mistaken, with horror movies.
It was the first. Yeah.
One of the first movies where they used that technique where the person's in the foreground in focus and you see the quick walk by in the background out of focus, which always freaked me. The first time I saw that, I'm like, he's behind you!
It was the first of the slasher films of the late 70s, early 80s that actually made a boatload of money. And back then, this movie made maybe $40 million. Not a lot nowadays, but back then, this was a major hit. So we have a return 20 years later. The only good thing about this movie is that it's produced by Kevin Williamson, who wrote Scream and I Know What You Did Last Summer and Scream 2. Too bad he didn't write this one.
You know, thing I read about this is that unlike Scream and I Know What You Did Last Summer, where they actually show a lot of the gore, they said this one doesn't show a lot.
First 45 minutes, it actually tries to build the plot of Jamie Lee Curtis running
elite
boarding school in California. Mm-hmm. It's 20 years after her brother Michael Myers went on this rampage, and it's 20 years to the day he decides to come pay her a visit and rekindle family ties. At that point, about 40, 45 minutes, maybe even an hour into the movie, is when all the slashing begins.
Michael Myers right there, everybody.
Movie.
You know, for my money, and I like Scream and I like Scream 2, those movies, but when you really want a scary movie, like some of the old scary movies, the scariest of scary movies, it's kind of like it's not a payoff when you see the person actually get it, because then it's like, okay, who's next to get it? But when they build up like...
Mike, violence is in the eye of the beholder.
I know.
I knew we were going to get into a debate with you on this. It's just, I remember the movies that
I love seeing the head getting cut off and seeing it spin around and seeing blood come out.
Like Silence of the Lambs, which I think that scene at the end when Jodie Foster's down in the cellar where she's walking around. Not a lot of real blood and guts down there, but man, the tension is just killing you.
You know what that's akin to? That's akin to, and I know a lot of people like this, who think that in a movie that's a romantic movie,
right,
that it's much sexier to see the people, like from a neck shot up, where you know that they're going to make love, and then the screen fades to black, and then the next thing is the morning after. Mm-hmm. Same thing. I'd rather see people boning.
Right.
I'd rather see someone get their head cut off.
Yeah, but do you think it's as scary? I mean, legitimately as scary. Certainly it's, you know, for entertainment value. It's the truth. Entertainment value, like a movie like Scream, has its place. But when you talk about the movies that I remember, the one where it was Mia Farrow playing the blind lady? What was that movie called where she couldn't see and there was a guy that was stalking her throughout the house and there was no blood and guts, but it was the whole movie where she was being chased by this guy, and every 5 minutes you're totally freaked out. I like movies like that.
No idea what movie that is.
Me
the
either.
Woody Allen story.
See No Evil. See No Evil was the movie.
Before my time.
Yeah, it's an old movie. It's an old movie.
And the bad guy's named Mike Myers, right?
Yes, it is.
Michael Myers.
Do I make you horny?
I tried to work that in before.
Smashing Baby.
Just kind of flew right past that.
Mike Myers.
All right, so Halloween, H2O. What else, Chuck?
The other one is Snake Eyes. This is the Nicolas Cage film that...
you know who really wants to see that? It's Charlie Stuang Stabilak, only because he loves the title. He runs around the office just screaming, Snake Eyes, Snake Eyes.
Snake Eyes! Snake Eyes, Ben!
I like Nicolas Cage.
Nicolas Cage is very good in the movie because he plays an over-the-top character, much like he did in Face Off. If you like that frantic Nicolas Cage, you've got this. He is He's an Atlantic City detective who witnesses the murder of the Department of Defense, the Secretary of Defense, at a boxing match. This Navy guy is supposed to, played by Gary Sinise, is supposed to watch him. Navy guy turns his back, leaves. There's an assassination attempt. He gets killed.
Looks
and
so
at that
boring.
Point, Nicolas Cage tries to figure out the conspiracy and everything that goes involved with this to try to help his buddy get off so to speak.
I agree. It looks boring because in the ads, they give you the whole plot of the movie, but this is one movie that I would go to see even with that because I'm a big Nicolas Cage fan.
I think if you are a Nicolas Cage fan, that you're going to like it, especially
I like Gary
just watching
Sinise.
Him.
I like Gary Sinise, too. Yeah.
He plays it very over the top. It was better than I thought it was going to be, especially with all the stuff I've heard from Paramount that this movie really blew. That's what they kept on telling me. They pushed it back to this August release date, and basically in August is The Wasteland. August and September don't really do great. You have one movie in August that maybe carries this business through into September, but you know, right now it's probably going to be perfect.
You notice how guys become movie stars so fast? Now, like, he's Captain Dan, right? And obviously, after he's Captain Dan...
Lieutenant Dan.
I'm sorry,
Dan.
Lieutenant Dan. Then he's in Ransom. Right. All of a sudden, out of nowhere, he's in Ransom. All of these guys, how come this doesn't happen for us?
He's Truman, Harry Truman. He was Harry Truman.
Oh, that's right.
On the TV
on HBO,
movie.
Right?
Right.
Very good role, too. I did happen to see, and those are the only two that come out this week, but there's one next week. I saw what might be the worst movie I have seen all year.
And if you hate it, it's got to be bad, because you generally love everything.
The Avengers.
Oh, that looks like
really?
It sucks. That looks like it can't suck enough.
This movie is moronic. It's sub-moronic.
When's
it's
the one with
bad.
The guy going to the gallows that goes down to South America or Malaysia?
Return to Paradise. That's
when is
21st.
That? I saw a trailer for that.
Hey.
Yay.
Hey.
Hey.
Yay. Ellen Booth.
Snake Eyes.
Yeah, that looks like an interesting plot
it
in that
really,
one.
It really, really does. The trailer was great. Is that...
It's a PolyGram film. It's a very small film company, and this is when the little studios release their stuff is end of August and September, and usually you find a gem, a nice little movie thrown in there somewhere, so maybe this will be it. They haven't screened it for us yet.
All right, thank you, Chuck Stossel.
Once married, twice shy, here's movie man, Charlie Stossel.
Way to gulp that drink, Charlie. Thank you, my friend. See you at the movies.
Bye-bye.
There's Chuck Stossel.
Man.
The mother chucker.
So glad. I just that soda. He looks like, you know, the teenage girl at the malt shop the way he drinks it.
Hello, John and Mike show.
Hi. I just wanted to say your guys' show is great. We listen to it all the time, me and my mom. And I have a few questions for you.
Oh, mother and daughter team. Yeah,
woo!
Baby.
Snake Eyes.
Yes, what do you want?
It's about Lewis.
What about Lewis?
Well, I had asked before, but somebody told me that he was like 23 years old, and I was just wondering if he had a girlfriend at all.
Have we ever asked Lewis that? No, he couldn't have a girlfriend and be, you know, hanging over Christine.
I believe Lewis has a relationship with his left hand. I don't think there's a gal.
Is there any way possible that you could send me a picture of him?
You're attracted to Lewis.
Well, I mean, I was listening to him. We just got home.
My God.
Why don't you ask your mother? Has your mother heard Lewis?
Oh, yeah. Both of us have.
And
yeah,
she approves also?
Time. Huh?
All right. Listen, I'll just put you on hold. He's still here. You can talk to him.
Wow. Okay.
You want to talk to him?
I guess. I don't know.
Because we think if you log some time, well, with you, I'm not sure, but maybe if you log a little time with him.
You'd grow to hate him as much as we do.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
You'd like to beat his ass with a writing crop like we did.
But there's something about him that has attracted you, right?
Yeah.
Well, new movie, there is something about Lewis. All right, Tammy, hold on a second.
Okay.
All right, Lutard.
That'd be a Walt Disney picture.
Line number three is for you, Lutard. Hello.
Something about Lewis.
Hey, buddy.
Buddy.
How you doing?
Doing great, thanks.
I was just curious. I go to school in Miami, but I'm here for the summer every summer.
Yeah.
Are you guys ever going to get on down there?
I don't know, man.
WIOD, many moons ago, was the station we were on down there, and they were another one of those stations that kind of messed with the show.
Yeah. So I don't know. Listen, there's all kinds of places we'd like to be.
Oh, man, I hope you guys get on down there, because, like, summers are, like, the best time of my life, man.
Bummer every summer, man.
That's nice of you to say.
Thank you.
All right. Have fun smoking.
I always do.
Smoking.
Don and Mike show.
Yeah, I'd like to talk to Don and Mike, please.
Yeah, you're on the air. Hello.
Yeah.
Hello, radio up too loud.
Yes, turn that radio down, please.
Got it.
Right, like I'm going to wait 20 minutes for you. quick break, and then we'll come right back.
This is the Don and Mike Show.
The Don and Mike Show on 98.1 The Peak.
I killed me.
What?
Like the woodpecker, they will please you.
Here we go.
Don and Mike.
You know the guy that's Homer Simpson? What's his name? It's Dan... What's his name,
Castellano.
That's it, Castellano. Anybody watch the Raymond show on Monday? It was a repeat.
Mm-hmm.
The one where Raymond's kids... are playing T-ball.
Okay, all
and
right.
And they had the big fight about bringing the correct snacks.
Yeah, that's right.
The dad that was real uptight about the snacks.
Same guy?
Homer Simpson.
You know what? I got a old computer program called Virtual Springfield that I'm playing with my daughter.
Oh, we've
now.
Got that, yeah. Oh,
that is so much fun. It really is. Yeah, you go in, you know, you get to go into the convenience store and do all the, be very careful or I will dance on your bullet-riddled carcass.
That guy looks nothing like you pictured the voice of Homer Simpson because he's skinny and bald.
Really?
Yeah, sure. And his real voice sounds nothing like Homer Simpson's. He was also on that...
Tracy Ullman show.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah, her show. Yeah. Right. Thank you, Buzz.
Dan Castellaneta is the guy's name.
Castellaneta.
I can't believe that we missed the gay games.
We did?
Are you aware that the gay games were in Amsterdam recently?
Oh, no. My God. I would have been working out.
That's right. It may not matter who won or lost the women's softball competition. What counts is how they played the game. The fame would be true of the big German guys in tutus hammering at each other on the badminton court. Here, in the fifth annual gay games in North America, in the shores of North America, in Amsterdam, they had the gay games this past week.
Really?
Yeah, where a bunch of homos and lesbians get together.
The gay games.
To pump iron, to throw their hammers.
Oh, man, I tell you, we should have been hip to that. We could have reignited the furor over Hello Gorgeous, best museum in the world.
Said hammer.
Oh, no.
The gay games, they would be called the Gay Olympics if the International Olympic Committee hadn't sent their lawyers in.
Oh, I can't believe they're that uptight.
They've always been more than just a gay athletic competition.
You know, it's one of the reasons why the Nude Olympics became sex, pies, and videotape, because of that Olympic committee.
Correct. All right, well, we'll call over to Amsterdam here. Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Hey, guys, how you doing?
Hey, Baldy.
I foresee a natural disaster tonight if we don't take some quick action.
What?
I think Dennis might be going out with a loaded gun.
What do you mean?
Oh, you know what he means.
You know what I mean.
You know, something
we
about...
make sure he doesn't leave any hair gel hanging.
Something
on.
About Mary. And you know what? When we sent Dennis out to Reno to be with a prostitute a couple of years ago, you must not have heard that. Here's why we're not going to send Dennis out with a loaded gun.
Mm-hmm.
Because we had Dennis fire his gun.
Right.
Before he went with a prostitute.
Mm-hmm.
And then as it turns out, he couldn't get any more ammo later when he was...
Single shot?
I think he's like Barney Fife. He's got one bullet in his gun.
Thank you.
Okay.
One bullet per week.
Bye-bye. Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Hi, Don and Mike.
Hi.
A couple weeks ago, I was watching that Two Fat Broads, the two cooks on the Food Channel.
Love that show.
The Two Fat Pigs. Have you seen those ladies?
They are fantastic. Yeah. They ride around in one drives a motorcycle, the other one's in a sidecar, and they have completely let themselves go, and they don't care about it. And they cook with lard, too.
Hello. We're going to today...
Homemade lard.
We're going to make a lovely fish with just some lard.
And broad cheese.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but what about them?
Well, one day they were doing like some tea episode, and they pulled out this tin of stuff. It was an anchovy paste called Gentleman's Relish.
Oh, no. Are you kidding me?
I'm 99.9% sure, because when you guys started talking about that, I remember thinking, I heard of that stuff.
Oh, my God. Bill Clinton's face wasn't on the tube, was it?
No, guy in the top hat.
Roll your dough, spread it out, and then pour on the Gentleman's Relish.
Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Hello?
Hello.
Hey, my best friend is going to the premiere of Anne Heche's new movie with Anne Heche on Monday.
Wow.
Really? How does your friend know Anne Heche?
His mom is Ellen's cousin. And
really?
He's going down to Southern California to check out colleges.
Yeah.
And he needed a place to stay, so she called up her aunt. And he's going to be staying at the house down there. And apparently Ellen couldn't make it to the premiere. So... They asked my friend if he wanted to go with Ann.
Oh, you should have your friend call our show on Monday. Are you lying?
No, I'm not lying.
This is so cool.
Isn't it the coolest?
Real Hollywood stuff.
We're all jealous. Here.
I'd love to talk to Ann Heche. I'd like to ask all kinds of questions like, who's the man and who's the woman?
Sure. Are you really in love with her?
There you go. We were thinking, since he's going to be going with her, that he could, like, grab her butt and stuff and make it look like, you know, they were really, really together. Have some pictures taken like that.
Isn't that always like the friends to grab her butt while you're at the premiere?
Yeah, we're all cheering for that here. Hoping to get maybe some celebrity underwear or something.
Well, I know a lot of people that see Anne Heche on screen kind of wish that she was heterosexual because she's got hottie potential.
There's something about... She needs... First off, someone needs to introduce her, like, to Max Factor or something like that. She's... She's got to paint herself up, right?
Trowel it on, Don.
You know, like Ellen. Well, first of all, there's not enough makeup in the world to fix Ellen, but Anne Heche has some potential.
Maybe Joker makeup. Maybe
new and improved Joker products.
New and improved Joker products.
Yeah, Anne Heche. Nice. Heche.
Looks good in that movie, too. I saw the trailer for it, and she really does look good in that movie.
Well, listen, hold on a second. We need to get some information from you, because maybe your friend could get Anne Heche to call the show.
I'll see if I can work that. Sure.
I'd like to ask the strap-on question. Did you ever strap it on for Ellen? All right, thank you. Hold on, please.
Sure.
All right, now listen. Hold on. Let's do something with the gay games real fast.
Okay.
Let's call... How about we call the Amsterdam police to find out how it went?
Very good.
Good start.
Good chance to speak our fabulous international language of love.
Oh, and we do have a new Lobot to Jeopardy coming up for you in a moment. Mm-hmm. And Guy Birdley also with the Monica report today.
Right. Yeah. The latest.
Yeah.
You haven't heard anything about her having an abortion, have you?
No, not a word.
Have you been watching CNN?
I've had it on, yeah, so they've been busy with other things.
Oh, right, that bombing.
Hello?
Yes, hello?
Goedendag, politiebureau Pieter Haafstraat.
Yes, Amsterdam. Don't you guys speak English? Hello.
Bonjour. Mama hello. Puts the pies out to cool.
Hello.
Hello.
This is the Don and Mike show from America. We're on the radio right now.
We'd like to ask you some questions about the gay games.
Sorry, we have a different
what?
Is this Amsterdam?
This is Amsterdam, yes.
Listen. On your police cars, do they go, beep-doop, beep-doop, beep-doop?
And do the police chase the crooks in wooden shoes?
Sorry, I don't understand you. What's your question?
All right, here was one of the... I'm asking a question about the competition of the gay games.
Yes.
Did they have a competition to see who could put their finger in the dike? Don't they have dikes in Amsterdam, right?
Are the gay games still going on?
The gay games are still going on.
Oh, they're going on.
What's the most popular event at the gay games?
I don't know.
Who's the toss my salad champion?
I don't know.
The 20-meter carpet crawl?
I don't know.
Listen.
I can't answer any question about these things.
Have you had... You're working at the police department, can you tell me...
Yes, but the police department in Amsterdam is very big, and we have a similar thing for answering questions to the press. So you have to call that tomorrow at daytime.
I can't do that. We're not doing the show tomorrow. Can we, Billy? It's Friday.
I can't help you anymore.
It's so difficult. We've got so many questions about the gay games, and you can't answer any of them?
No. I'm sorry.
Can you just tell me one last question? When do the gay games end? When are they over?
Tomorrow.
When's the climax?
Tomorrow.
Oh, tomorrow.
I bet
that's going to be a fabulous closing ceremony.
The 8th of August.
Oh, dang.
Who's going to be performing at the closing ceremonies?
Yeah, you go and tell me. I tell you. I don't know.
You don't know?
No.
It's raining, Ben.
The weather girl.
Hallelujah.
Hey, you know the weather girl.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, way to go. You're very sophisticated.
Are you gay like we are?
No, sorry.
Oh, you're not?
No.
Who's the celebrity you most resemble?
I'll tell you who I look
I'm
like.
I'm going to end this telephone.
I kind of look like Donald Sutherland.
I have to answer other calls. I'm very sorry. Have a nice evening.
I resemble the late James Coco.
Hello. Yeah.
Okay, bye.
See you later.
All right,
you know what was tough doing that? She sounded like a hottie.
Yeah.
She had that, hello, I want to be alone.
Amsterdam hottie. Well, we should have asked her about the Dutch oven because she was in Amsterdam. I totally forgot about that.
Whenever in Amsterdam, visit the Dutch oven.
All right. Well, you know what? If it ends tomorrow, good. Rob, let's just put that number aside for Monday then. All right?
Find out all about the closing ceremony. Yeah, the Vetter Girls.
Clothing and opening ceremony. Yeah.
Hello.
Who's pitching and who's catching?
Well, we'll call. We'll call on Monday to find out all about it.
It is. Hello, Don and Mike show. Hello.
Hello, Don.
Hey, buddy.
Hey, how you doing?
Great, thanks.
Hey, I got a special report for you on Bill Clinton. And straight from the White House.
Wait, hold on. Are you calling? Please, time out. Are you calling with a Bill Clinton joke?
Well, I don't think it's a joke.
No, please.
Bill Clinton's not a joke. He's a serious president.
Now, what are you talking about, and what are your sources? What is going on?
This sounds to me like it's going to be another setup for she found a wad of bills.
No. It only takes a moment.
This is not one of those, the whitest teeth I've ever come across jokes.
Although that one made us laugh yesterday.
I told that one last night.
You believe in truth.
Hey, just,
right?
You know something? Just keep talking when we're talking, sir. That always works real well.
Just please answer the question. Are you calling? Is this a joke about Clinton?
Yes.
Yeah, I knew it.
All right. Then before you give this joke, please tell us your name and address.
And your phone number.
Right. See, when you're held accountable for your material, suddenly the joke's not that funny, right?
Fine. My name is Tom, and I'm calling from Massachusetts.
Yeah, that's not good enough, Tom.
What is your phone number, Tom?
My phone number, that would be 1-800.
Ask for ass.
Don't give me the ask for ass line.
You guys are pretty funny. You know, I've been listening to you guys for years. You always make me laugh.
All right.
Thanks, Tom.
All right. Thank you, Tom.
Don, this Bill Clinton thing.
I knew that was a joke. I knew it was a Clinton joke.
Yeah, the whitest teeth. I still enjoy that one.
A wad of bills on her dress. Hello?
Hey, yeah, can I talk to Mark, please?
Mark?
Yes.
Sounds to me there's another joke. I think we're walking into another joke here.
Is this another joke?
I'm sorry. I'm looking for a guy named Mark.
No, you're not.
Who's this?
No, you're not.
Come on.
Who's this?
Come on. Who are you calling?
Mark.
No. Why would Mark be at a 1-800 number?
Because that's his number.
No, it's not.
No, it's not.
Tell the truth.
Don't lie to us.
I'm looking for a guy named Mark. Who's this?
We got crap detectors bigger than the entire state of California.
Our crap detector's bigger than Monica Lewinsky's mouth.
Yeah, the Navy wants to use our crap detectors for submarine communications.
Who is this?
Oh, listen, Mark just called up. He said go F yourself.
Oh, boy, he doesn't like you anymore. He said he doesn't want to be your friend anymore.
Well, who did I reach?
Mark's friends. His new friends.
His real friends.
Yeah, Mark said he if that guy calls...
Hey, what's your first name?
He's gone.
There you go. Hey, listen, and if you're Mark, sorry about that. Right? We had no idea. Just don't give him our number, Mark.
Sorry, Mark.
All right, we'll be right back.
This is the Don and Mike Show.
The Don and Mike Show on 98.1 The Peak.
CNN Radio News. I'm Stan Case. The United States is rushing medical supplies, security teams, and investigators to...
Good old WJFK in Washington, D.C. And thanks a buttload for listening to the show. And have a great weekend in Albuquerque, New Mexico. Our show's on every day from 1 till 5 on Hot Rock KHTL.
Yeah!
In Las Vegas, noon till 4 every day. KVBC 105.1 FM in Oxnard / Ventura, California. Noon till 4 every day in Southern California on KTRO. Baldy. Vegas-style shows coming to you soon. We got two of them coming up in this month.
Oh, boy.
August 20th. It'll be quadruple X-rated fun in Springfield, Virginia, when we do our live Las Vegas-style show at Blackie's / Lulu's.
Blackie's Lulu's.
And then for the first time ever, Las Vegas-style show in Ocean City, Maryland.
Yeah, we're going to have a great time down there.
We're going to be at Secrets on Coastal Highway, and that is on August 26th. We'd love to see you at both those shows. Don't cost nothing to get in. We got our free plastic key tags and all the raunchy fun.
Oh, you'll love it.
Of the Vegas-style shows. We've got two coming up in August. And now, let's play the game.
It's game time now on JFK with cash for you and me.
Ah!
It's time for Don and Mike to play.
No budget, Jeff Hardy.
Hello, hello. Hello, hi.
Hey, it's...
good.
Zorro.
Zorro. And I've,
hey, Antonio.
Hi. It's good to see you. Hi, please. This is...
Sword fight.
Sword fight. I practice... sword fighting for the movie, which is... good, Zorro. You like Zorro?
No, I think Zorro sucks.
Oh, you don't like? Come on. Everyone likes Zorro, Dan. And, everybody likes sword fighting. Everybody enjoys the movie. I do not play the original Zorro. I am Alejandro. I play Alejandro. I train to be Zorro from... Anthony Hopkins. He trained me to be Zorro.
Let me introduce you.
He plays Zorro as an old man.
Ladies and gentlemen,
yeah,
one of the great mumblers of our time.
Oh, come on.
Right,
yeah.
Little Antonio Banderas. Isn't he marvelous?
Yeah,
right,
okay.
Yeah.
You flower.
Little Antonio, he's marvelous.
You flower me. You flower me.
I flower you?
Flower me. You do. Fly. Yes. Yeah.
What?
Booze. How are you?
Hi, Antonio.
Congratulations on, you know, being well.
Thank
again.
Thank you, Antonio.
Pass. It's good. You want me to talk about the movie, Zorro?
No. We just want to get to know you, Antonio Banderas. Who's your wife?
It's Melanie Griffith.
Oh, Melanie Griffith.
She's beautiful. Right. She's so beautiful.
She got the fun bags, right?
Oh, she's so fun bags?
Fun bags.
Oh, you mean...
Her yabos.
Oh, yeah. Braced.
Her what?
Breast.
Oh, her breast.
She is beautiful. I want to say, I'll tell you a story about Melanie.
Okay, great, Antonio.
She was in the room where they cook food.
Kitchen,
yes. She was in the room where she cooks food.
Can I tell you how great your English is?
Oh, thank you.
When you were on the Jay Leno show a couple of weeks ago, mumbling and stumbling so much you could hardly make out what you were saying.
He's a sweetheart. He's a sweetheart. I love...
He's a sweetheart?
I love Jay Leno. He is a sweetheart. And Jay Leno... He's such a sweetheart of a man. I like being on the pictures, the box.
Television.
Yes. That's he's a sweetheart. So the story. Melanie is in the kitchen.
Yeah, there you go. You got it.
Whatever. And she is she's making a coca sandwich.
She's making a what?
She is making Melanie is in the kitchen and she is making a coca sandwich for me.
A coca sandwich?
Coca.
Cold, you know?
Yes. Coca. She makes coca meat. Piece of meat.
Yes.
Okay.
Cold cut.
Yeah.
I got you. Okay.
In the room where they make the food. In the home with my children. And she's making a coca sandwich. And I sneak. I come into the room. And
how is it possible that you made a movie? You can barely. You are limping through this interview.
Oh, no. The movie is so good because the movie starts out with sword fighting. Lots of sword fighting. I like that with Zorro because he is a big sword fighter. The sword fighters are so good in this movie. We do not do all the sword fighting. They are other the stuntmen. They do sword fighting with the movie. You know.
Stunt. You know what I've noticed here? When there's a word that has like a D at the end of it.
D. Yeah.
Like when you were trying to say cold cuts.
Oh,
it's a hard D.
Oh, come
cold
on.
No, cuts.
You give me a hard time. You try to give me a hard time, and I don't want you to give me a hard time. Come on.
Hard.
Now.
Say hard. Hard. Say the name of the TV show. Hard Copy.
Hard Copy is a good show. Hard Copy. I am a smart man. You let me make you okay. I understand where you go, and I don't want to what do you do? You get angry.
Right.
With you, but I will tell you that I am a smart man. In my country, Spain. Spain,
I don't doubt that you're probably the Albert Einstein of Spain.
Oh, yes. I am one of the, one of the bold and beautiful people.
Bold.
Okay, it's easy. Bold.
No.
Bowl is something you do.
Hard copy.
Bowl is something you do with a ball when you throw it at the pins. Bold.
Sure and tie.
Sure and tie. Not sure and tie.
Sure and tie. I go out to the first show of the movie. There's a word. The first time.
The premiere?
Yay!
The premiere.
And I wear a shirt and tie to look good. You know, normally, when I'm in the room, in the house, in the home.
Bedroom?
Where the TV is.
Family room?
No, no. Now the TV room.
Living
yes, the TV room.
The TV room.
Yes, I mean the TV room. I don't wear a shirt and tie, but yeah, actually, I mentioned the ball. The ball in the beautiful is a soap opera, and that is
soap.
That is so good.
Soap. See, you got a problem. It's consonants.
Soap opera.
Soap.
Okay.
Opera.
I got soap opera. Okay, there's your P, opera. I pronounce a P like everybody
say
else.
Say soap.
How come I not talk about Zorro? You know, I can't be done here. If we're talking about the sword fighting, talking about Antonio Hopkins, T.C. Zorro. I play Alejandro. We get Raphael. He's the big guy. We go around, you know, the thing. Can I say about the movie
yes.
where I play Alejandro, the sword fighting is so beautiful. It is like a dance.
What is 2 plus 2?
2 plus 2. Oh, no. Two plus two.
Yes, 2 plus 2.
2, 3, 4.
You got it.
I see. Yeah. I'm not like some of the others.
What do you mean?
Don't try to make me look stupid. They said they weren't. They said, Antonio, when you go to Don Geronimo's show, you will be. You'll be. They make you out to be because you don't speak English so good. First of all, they tell you you're not a hard worker. They say you don't work hard. You don't work hard. They say you will not. I will tell you that Siskel and Iber will. They love the movie.
Siskel
Zorro.
And who?
Siskel. A smart man, Antonio. Siskel and Iber love Zorro. Love Zorro. In the beginning of the movie, Zorro, I play Alejandro, a young man who's angry at the war because he is so mad because they kill his brother. Oh. And when they kill my brother, I get so angry. I just want to kill everybody.
I'd like to see you play Jeopardy against Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Oh, Arnold Schwarzenegger, he's a big star, yes. A very nice man. A very nice man. He's so nice. He is a sweetheart. He is so sweetheart.
He's a what?
He's such a sweetheart. He's sweetheart.
There you go.
Sweetheart.
Okay. Pronounce the T and the D.
Sweetheart. Sweetheart.
Sweetheart.
Sweetheart. Arnold. Schwarzenegger is a good guy, and I like him. Okay?
Okay,
we're talking about the movie Zorro. Antonio Venice, you're talking about Melanie. I was telling a story when she was in your room where they make food.
Her fun bags. Yeah. We're talking about her fun bags.
So I sneaking, you know, like a cat. And I go in back of her. She's making me a coca sandwich, so she does not know where I am in the room. And so I come in back, and I grab her phone bag.
Her phone bag.
Oh, so much fun. She's a very beautiful girl, a woman, a little lady. She there.
Do you violate her a lot?
Viola?
Do you violate her?
Viola.
You know what I mean?
Violate.
In and out?
Oh, do I make love?
Yeah. Oh. Do you bone her?
I make Melanie.
Do you bang her?
I make love and the bang. Oh, all day long. She's so beautiful and she wants me all the time because I am, you know, Antonio Banderas. And she says, Antonio. The way she talk, you get a little irritating. You know, I try to keep her quiet so we make love. She does not talk when we make love. That is the rule of the house. Antonio Banderas, rule of the house. Melanie, please. For the love of God, please don't. When we make love, in the room, the room upstairs that has the bed.
Bedroom.
The bedroom. That's where we make love most of the time. And she if she talk,
does it go
no longer beam. Have an erection. If she talk, okay? Really? Is it okay to say erection?
Sure.
The president, okay? He's in trouble with the gentleman's relation. Funny guy. He's really a funny guy. I tell you right now that she does not talk when we make love. If Melanie speaks in her squeaky high voice, we making love, we don't have anything. We like to have fun. We play car together.
You play car?
We play car together, yes.
Cards. Yeah.
Yes, Buzz. Buzz, hey, so together. Good you feel well. You play, do you play car? You play car? Yeah, we play car together. Play play car is fun. We drink iced tea and we play car. all day long with Melanie. And then I grab her fun bag. Like, don't hear anyone say, grab the fun bag. Zorro, yes, I play Alejandro. I don't have this lack of good. Let me please say one thing.
Yes, Antonio.
If you want to see a good film, what you do is... You go if you like sword fighting, you go see Zorro. You love it. You go see sword fighting. That's the best thing in the movie. Lots of horses running around, fights, very sweaty, hot, you know, steamy. Great lady, beautiful woman.
What about the scene that we see in all the ads where you take your sword and you go wish, 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 and then her dress comes off?
Oh, there's a scene, a beautiful, beautiful scene that where I take the sword. I take my sword out of the scabbard, and as I pull the sword out of the scabbard, the eyes meet with each other, and then I go, peek, peek, and her dress comes out, and almost we see her fun bag. Wow. But no, I don't give away anything about the plot. I'm so happy to be here. It's so good to be on this show. Rayo is so good in America. It's not in Spain. Radio in Spain, you know, we have not as fun as you have here. Radio is good. And people love Antonio Banderas here. I can walk into the street or walk people walk up to me and say, how you do, Zorro? And I say, hey, bueno, hey, good to see you too. Yeah, we have Melanie's fun bag. Bueno, it's such a good time. I'm a smart man. You know, you should remember that. I'm a smart man.
There's a saying we have in this country that you are something as a box of rocks. You are
something. Is hard as a box of rocks.
No,
you dirty boy. Dirty boy. Unless Melanie talk loud. No. That is not. I am not hard as a box of rocks when that happens.
No. You are. Have you heard this? Dumb as a box of rocks.
Oh, thank you. I appreciate that. You know, thank you. I hope you go see Zorro, and you compliment me after you see Zorro. Okay.
I just gave you a very high compliment.
I
you
understand.
Are dumb as a box of rocks.
Yeah, I am ha.
You're hot.
Yes. Scalding hot. Scalding hot. The movie Zorro. Antonio, right now the top the premiere of the game. Yeah. Number one in the game, Antonio Banderas. And my English is good, eh?
Oh, you're English. Yes, he's fantastic.
Better with the English. I learned all the English watching the Bold and Beautiful. That's how I watch. And I learn from a dialogue when, for example, they come in and she say, Rick, I got banus. Banus for you.
Banus?
Banus. The doctor says that she gonna die. And I say, well, okay. Thank you, Bold and Beautiful, for letting me speak. Because you speak English is not easy for Antonio Banderas. I try hard, though. And next time you come to the premiere, we wear a shirt and tie. Shirt and tie.
Shirt and tie.
People say, I don't understand you, Antonio. I say, listen careful to the word. If you listen carefully to the word, you know that I speak perfect. Perfect. Because perfect speak, then you listen quietly, you be quiet and listen to the guest talk, and then we go on to the... I will say one thing to your listening audience.
Yes, Antonio.
The listener, hi. This is Antonio Banderas. I'd just like to say, you please go see Zorro and enjoy this sword fighting. It will be a good movie for all the family to see. Muchas gracias. Thank you very much. I play Alejandro.
Oh, we heard that. You're Zorro, right?
Zorro. Swish, swish. Yes.
Zorro.
I love the sword fighting. I hope you go see the movie, please. Please, you go see. Go to the premiere. Where's Sean Ty?
What about, you know, a good movie? Have you seen there's something about Mary?
Yes. Cameron Diaz.
Yes, Cameron Diaz in that movie, right? You know the thing that Ben Stiller did?
Ben Stiller, yes.
Where he had the goo hanging from his ear?
Oh, yeah,
and
yeah.
Then she put it in her hair and it made her hair stand up?
Yeah.
You ever do that with Melanie?
Yes, see. You let me cut out of the bag all over. Well, Antonio, how do I put this family show? They say you can say a certain thing. When Antonio has the thing happen, you know?
Yes.
I say, okay. Just all over.
All over the place.
Yes, it's raining. It's raining like a shower. Like a big Antonio shower. A Spanish shower, that's what we call that. You know,
a shower of your gentleman's relish.
Oh, my relish. Oh, I have enough relish to the whole ball game can eat the hot dogs. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
big shower, yes, gooey shower. There we go. Watch out, Antonio is excited. It's shower time, Melanie.
All right, let's play Low Budget Jeopardy right now.
Yeah, bueno, it's good. Good to be here, yes.
Because you're such a smart man and because you're so well-spoken.
Thank you.
I'd like you to be the announcer for the game.
And a hard worker. Don't forget a hard worker.
Yes, and you're not wearing a shirt and tie today, are you?
No, shirt and tie. I wear a polo shirt today, a golf shirt.
Okay.
Golf shirt today.
I know. You're trying to say golf.
Golf.
I know what you're trying
golf,
to say.
Golf. I play golf sometimes.
Golf, right.
Yeah, I like that. It's easy, fun sport.
Fun sport?
He's a very fun. I love,
you know, that's another
I love
word.
American sport. Basketball is a great American sport. Football is fantastic.
See, all these words, there's the T. Sport.
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 Football. Not football. Football.
You talk about my foo? You think I have a foo odor?
No, not.
You think I have Antonio does not have full order. I will take my shoes off. I will take my sandals off. I'm wearing sandals right now. Big black sandals. You see the hair on top of my toes?
Yes. Oh.
Big black matted hair on top of my toes. I have one problem. You will see in an Antonio movie, they never photograph the feet because the feet are so covered with hair. I have feet just like a baby monkey. That's it. And so they are covered. They said, Don't shoot his feet. Do not shoot his feet. Beware. Okay, now you know.
First two calls right now at 1-800-636.
My secret.
1067. And we'll play Low Budget Jeopardy. I tell you what, Mr. Big Shot, why don't you take us to break, please? Antonio Banderas.
Okay. This is Antonio Banderas. Please go see the movie Zorro, and we'll be right back.
Hey, very good.
We'll be right back.
Very good. You forgot the K, but it's okay.
Bueno.
Say okay.
Okay. Okay.
Fooled into that one.
I got the letter. Oh, I'm confused.
Be right back.
This is the Don and Mike Show.
The Don and Mike Show.
Hasn't got laid in 2 years. And he has missed that.
Yeah, but I mean...
We're trying... And so I'm focusing on Carl. I'm trying to find Carl somebody, you know?
Yeah.
Because this dry spell has gone a lot longer than mine.
Yeah. Why didn't you just get in the closet and blow up Bambi there? You and Carl go to the Philippines. Yeah, why don't you, Carl? That's a good idea.
Your radio sounds funny in the morning. You're listening to Imus in the morning.
There's some lucky lady missing out on this guy. You don't know what you're missing, ladies.
Yeah, boy, just what a smooth operator you are. Yeah, I'm really in a dry spell here. Carl hasn't got laid in 2 years.
At least
God, I can't understand why the women are just not ringing your phone off the hook, Fred.
I'll tell you what a person has to do. You got to do like the president does, just lower your standards.
That'll
just go out and get you a fat pig. You don't need to come.
Golf's best kept secret.
What is the name?
Seinfeld.
Yay, Seinfeld. Oh, bueno. Very funny. Very funny. Just like you.
All right.
Very funny guy.
Zorro, yes. Antonio Banderas, let's play Low Budget Jeopardy.
I read this card they gave me to read.
Please do in your best English.
This is Low Budget Jeopardy. Now entering the studio is a teacher from Helico City. Let's say hi to Laura Silver.
Hello, Laura.
Hi.
And now, entering the studio is a returning champion. He's one-day tour is $59. He is a police officer from Liber. Let's say hi to George Harvey.
Hey, George. Hi, Antonio. How's it going?
George, being our returning low-budget Jeopardy champion, how has it changed your life?
Oh, I've had great things and celebrity status. I don't know where to start.
What's
going to do the magic show?
Hey, you are a dynamo. And now entering the studio is your host. I'm sorry, the host of Low Budget Jeopardy, Laura and George. Please don't screw with that.
Don't screw without Q.
And say hi to Zorro himself, Electric Bay Geronimo.
Thank you, Antonio. And hello, George. Hello, Laura.
Hello.
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 Now, kids, don't forget to answer in the form of a question. I live in my mom clip on Thai Soup by Mr. Guy. Call me Alex as we're playing the game. That's or El Culo Chris Master. Please always call him Zorro.
Zorro, gracias. I think that's good. They promote them. I want to promote a movie. Mm-hmm. That's the thing. Promote a movie.
Mr. Funbags right there.
Funbags. Hey, Melanie, don't talk. Antonio.
Here are your categories, kids, and they are...
See.
Goodbye forever, Jerry Seinfeld.
Oh, adios, Mr. Seinfeld. Bye, sad day, sad day.
Famous guys named Mel.
Oh,
which is really just another opportunity to say our boss's name.
Hey, famous guy named Mel. Yeah, bueno.
Name that network.
Network. Oh, yeah, big time.
Dead or alive.
Oh, dead or alive.
And states and capitals.
State and capital. Okay, so, this is fun. This is a good show you have.
There they are. Goodbye forever, Jerry Seinfeld. Seinfeld.
Yeah,
name that network.
Network.
Famous guys named Mel.
Hello, man.
Hell, dead or alive?
They are alive!
And states and capitals. And Laura, you're the girl. We like girls better than boys. We'll start with you.
Okay. I'll take dead or alive.
Okay. Don't forget the form of question. Dead or alive? Walter Mondale.
What is alive?
Yes.
See, you have a $1, Laura. So you go again, please.
How about Goodbye Forever Seinfeld?
Oh, no. Look. You got to stick with the same category.
Oh, I'm sorry. Okay, dead or alive?
For two.
Yeah.
Robert Young.
What is dead?
Dead, yes.
$2 for you, and now you select again and mention the dollar amount. That is the way we play the game, Laura.
Oh, I didn't know that. I'm sorry.
Well, you should know these things. Okay.
Sorry, Zorro.
I'm sorry. You are very beautiful, I'm sure. You're a teacher. You teach our youth.
I'm a teacher.
Yeah, bueno.
Yeah.
Okay.
Not a Spanish teacher.
Oh, that's come okay. on, Laura, pick.
Dead or alive for three?
Three. There you go. Very nice. Burt Bacharach.
Burt Bacharach. What is alive?
Alive, yes, barely, and you are correct.
Did the teacher run the category? You
yes.
Can select did. Another category, Laura.
Okay, now I'll go to Goodbye Forever Seinfeld for $1, please.
All right, there you go. Goodbye Forever Jerry Seinfeld.
Oh, goodbye.
Number of seasons that the show Seinfeld ran on NBC.
What is nine?
Nine is correct. Antonio, I believe she's working on A Perfect Game. Oh. Carolina.
Oh, don't know.
Ah.
Oh, hey, George, it's your chance. George, it's your chance to steal.
Okay, what is Raleigh?
Raleigh, yeah, there hey. You go. He's like scalding hot water now.
He is scalding hot, the police officer. Go again, George.
We have name that network for $1.
Hey, this is all we have left now, kids. Name that network.
Name that network.
I will tell you the name of a show. You tell me what network it's on, okay?
Network, network, network.
Wayans Brothers.
What is UPN?
Oh. Oh, hey, Laura, you chance to steal.
What is Fox?
No.
Oh.
So close. The WB.
Ah, the WB. Oh, the WB. Okay. Yards, you're in control.
I have named that network for $2.
Early Edition.
What is CBS?
Yeah.
$2 for you, Yard. Go ahead.
What do you call? Oh, Rob's Climb just because it's a CBS show.
Yeah,
I got you.
There they go. Yeah, Mayor Carmichael.
Can I close out that category and name that network for $3?
Yes. Moesha.
Oh, bueno. Bueno, Arvista.
What is UPN?
UPN, hey, that is absolutely correct.
What about the FAW network?
The what network?
FAW.
Fox.
Yeah, see, FAW. FAW.
We don't have any questions about the FAW network.
I love FAW. I love America police chases.
FAW. Listen, what is the score, Antonio?
That's the end of the game, first round. Laura finished with a $14. George finished with $10.
All right, kids, both of you, sit right there. I'm going to put you on hold, and Antonio will be right back.
Oh, bueno, that's
with
good.
The second round. Oh, take us to break again, please, my well-spoken
friend.
You
trained me to do this thing the right way. Okay, this is the Donny Mike show. We'll be there right back.
This management, ownership, or advertisers of WPEK. This is the Don and Mike Show.
Now, back to the Don and Mike Show on 98.1 The Peak.
The Don and Mike Show wants to give you $5,000. Just listen to Don and Mike to qualify. And on Wednesday, August 26th, they'll give away the $5,000. Courtesy of Advantage Title. Call them at 703-352-2840. It's Mo Deep, Mo Life, and Mo Money. Only on the Don and Mike Show. 100% free of all sex diseases. Guaranteed. The Don and Mike Show.
All right, we're back with Final Low Budget Jeff R.D.
It's good to be back, and I want to say
Hi.
Hi, Antonio.
Hi.
George and Laura playing the game. Who's in the lead right now?
The lead is held by... Who hold the lead? Laura has 14, and the George has 10.
All right, guys, anything can happen in Final Low Budget Jeopardies, where we physically force you both to bet it all, so good luck.
Yeah, bueno.
And a tough one today. It's a Who Said That?
Oh, Who Said That?
Who Said That?
Who Said That?
This major Hollywood star said the reason for his successful marriage is he makes his wife laugh every day.
Okay.
And he picks up his underwear.
Oh, I never do.
This major Hollywood star.
He's no me.
Said the reason for his successful marriage is that he makes his wife laugh every day and he picks up his underwear.
Pick up underwear. Oh, hey, no, don't do that. You stupid guy.
All right, kids, don't forget answering the form of a question and good luck.
Okay.
Hold on. Music, please.
Music, please. This is Antonio Banderas.
Hold on. Here's your music, Antonio. Okay. There you go.
Okay. First of all contestants on a low budget Jeopardy receive one bottle of my sweat.
You do sweat a lot.
See. Now, if you saw the movie Zorro, you know I swear a lot, especially when I was surfing. So now I take my sweat, put in a little bottle for you, and you smell just like me. Antonio Banderas, my sweat to you. Gracias. And now back to the final Low Budget Jeopardy with Alex Irving.
Thank you, Antonio.
Thank you.
It's game time now on JFK with cash for you and me.
Who do we want to talk to first here, Antonio?
You want to go to George, or yours. Yours is, hey, man.
Jorge.
Okay.
Jorge.
Yes.
Jorge, this major Hollywood movie star said the reason for a successful marriage is he makes his wife laugh every day and he picks up his underwear.
Who is Tom Cruise?
Tom Cruise, no.
Oh, yours, the W down to zero. That's not good. That's no good.
Sorry. Laura.
Uh-huh.
Laura, you can be the big wiener if you have the correct answer.
Who is Antonio Banderas?
No, I said I don't. The feet of the underwear.
No, it's Tom Hanks.
Tom Hanks. Oh, Private Ryan.
Private Ryan.
Oh.
Sorry, no money today. Well, it's the kind of game that Ken Stevens will love. No cash being given away.
Oh, he's a cheesecake.
So, George and Laura, don't go away mad. Just go away. And now listen to the gifts that Antonio Banderas has for you.
Okay, congratulations to both of you for being on this show. You have won a United States Row Atlas from ADC, the awfully darn careful map people. Except no maps, the toads. Jeez, this is hard to read.
Yeah, I know. I try to read it every day. Tell me about it.
Don't just ask for direction, but wait.
There's more.
You have won breakfast for two at Planet Hollywood. Ah, Planet Hollywood. In celebration of the 30th anniversary of Planet of the Apes, where you will see never before seen behind the scene footage and have your picture taken with an A. Hey, how about that? An A. You get your picture taken. Thank you, Laura, and yours, and thank you for playing the game with Antonio Benitez.
Thank you.
Thank you, kids. Have a great weekend, and thank you for listening. And, well, Antonio, I guess it's back to the fun bags.
Oh, hey, fun bag with Melanie. I want to say to all you, being a sweetheart, you've been all sweetheart, and, you know, go see Zorro with lots of sword fighting. Right. I love all you. You're mwah. All good. You're good people. Yeah.
Don't forget that Low Budget Jeopardy is a production of
Corona Incorporated in distributed by King World. Fishers!
Thank you, Antonio.
He's very enthusiastic at the end.
He's got the vision.
Yes, he does.
Oh, Bazito. Hey, it's news and comment time. Already it's time for Monica and comment.
Yeah. How do you know?
All right, let's talk about her. Let's talk about her mouth. Let's talk about Monica Lewinsky. That's your lead story, right?
Indeed. Tonight the headline screams, Monica's private striptease shows.
Oh, baby.
Oh.
All right, news and comment with Buzz coming right up.
This is the Don and Mike Show.
The Don and Mike Show on 98.1 The Peak.
Good afternoon. I'm Pamela Graham reporting from the News Channel 7 newsroom for WPEK.
An emergency meeting has been called tonight in the Spartanburg County community of Chesney, where the police chief and six officers walked off their jobs yesterday. The Highway Patrol and the Spartanburg County Sheriff's Department have agreed to help patrol the city until the situation can be resolved. City Council is expected to discuss policies and procedures at tonight's 7:30 meeting. A 27-year-old mother convicted of mistreating her child has been arrested in Boston. Linda Evans was convicted Tuesday in Greenville County of shaking her 2-year-old son so badly that he suffered brain damage. Evans is being held without bail and is expected to be returned to South Carolina next week. I'm Pamela Graham, reporting for News Channel 7 and WPEK.
As you cross the expanse of marsh and pass through Kiowa's Gate, so begins your turn at the good life at Kiowa Island Resort. An easy drive from Greenville, Kiowa offers a coastal island experience unlike any other. You chart your course. Stroll along 10 miles of wide beach. Take a bike ride under canopies of live oaks. Or spend quality time with your children in a Kiowa nature program. You know the golf and tennis are among the best available, and historic Charleston is just a short drive away. With luxurious accommodations and world-class dining, you'll forget the hustle of the world you left behind. And right now is the perfect time to reserve your escape to this Four Diamond Resort. For a limited time, Kiowa Island Resort is offering special summer beach getaway packages. Call 1-800-6-KIOWA for a vacation that's uniquely Kiowa. That's 1-800-654-2924. Kiowa Island Golf and Tennis Resort, where getting away from it all is closer than you think. Uh-oh. Just what you were afraid of. A sudden downpour. You know, the kind that catches you unprepared, either running for cover or out on the road. A road that turns slicker with every rain-swept minute. Don't be caught off guard. Hurry down to Welburn Tire and Automotive at 1114 Salem Church Road in Anderson for special savings on Uniroyal Tiger Paw Aqua Grip Tires. Aqua Grip Tires have the best wet road traction of any Uniroyal Tiger Paw tire, courtesy of an advanced tread design that rapidly sheds the wet stuff. DuraShield construction for durability and an 80,000-mile tread life limited warranty. Uniroyal Tiger Paw Aqua Grip, available at special savings only at your Uniroyal dealer. Save big on all-season Uniroyal Tiger Paw Aqua Grip Tires at Welburn Tire and Automotive, 1114 Salem Church Road, Anderson, or call 224-6388.
A devastating flood. Thousands of lives in danger.
Has declared the region a disaster area.
Is there any way you can help? In the Army National Guard, you can.
Let's move, people. Let's go.
Call 1-800-GO-GUARD and find out how you can do your part.
In the Army National Guard, you can.
Sponsored by the South Carolina National Guard. Aired by the South Carolina Broadcasters Association and this station.
This is Brad Scott, head football coach of the University of South Carolina. This year, Gamecock football plays here on 98.1, The Peak, WPEK.
Like most beauty pageants, this one's not much different. There's bright lights, a runway, beautiful girls, a talent competition. Oh yeah, and the winner gets to do that famous runway walk wearing a crown. And nothing else. Diamond Show Club welcomes Miss Nude World 1998, Holly Montana, August 17th through the 22nd. This will be Holly's first upstate appearance, so let's make her feel welcome. Diamond Show Club is open Monday through Saturday at 6 p.m. and strictly BYOB. Diamond Show Club features 150 of the most beautiful women in the upstate on more stages than ever before, with a newly expanded VIP room. Make plans now to meet the woman that bears the title Miss Nude World 1998. Holly Montana, live on the Diamond Show Club stage, August 17th through 22nd. Diamond Show Club, Easley Bridge Road and Whitehorse Road in Greenville. Ladies, go as bare as you dare in another exciting Diamonds Amateur Contest, August 12th, worth $1,000.
Buying a new car? No doubt you're caught up in a frenzy of options. To sunroof or not to sunroof? A spoiler, perhaps? What about an option you might overlook? Lowering your car insurance rate. One 15-minute call to Geico Direct could save you 15% or more. Do it now, because you can't imagine what tears of regret due to new leather seats. Call 1-800-947-AUTO. That's 1-800-947-AUTO. Geico Direct, the sensible alternative.
This is Dr. Joy Brown. Please join me weekdays on WPEK. We'll sort through things that affect us all every day. Things like relationships, parenting, sex, whatever the issue, I promise to help you through it. Weekdays at 10 on 98.1, The Peak, WPEK.
Dr. Joy Brown on 98.1 The Peak is brought to you in part by Behavioral Health Services of Greenville Hospital System, serving the mental health and wellness needs of upstate families for over 30 years.
For CNN News on the Hour, it's 98.1 The Peak, WPEK, News, Talk, and Sports on FM.
This is the Don and Mike Show.
Now back to the Don and Mike Show on 98.1 The Peak.
Take the boy! Take the boy! And not me! I'm too young to die. Oh, the pain.
Don Geronimo and Mike O'Mara.
Yeah, baby. All right.
Hello, Don and Mike Show.
Hello, God. Hi, Mike. How you doing?
Hello, hey. Dennis.
It's, hey, it's Hang Gliding Man.
Huh?
Go ahead.
Hi, Dennis.
I took that Simmons hang gliding.
Did you actually hang glide yourself or did your girlfriend?
I actually hang glide myself.
Well, congratulations.
Thank you. It's unbelievable.
Let me play you in here.
Moo moo, coo coo. How you doing?
How you doing?
It's Let's Try to Get Dennis Murphy Laid Week, only on the Don and Mike Show.
So how are things going with Julie?
Hey, so far, so good. We were hugging, we were talking, and we will see what happens.
Feeling good about it, Dan?
Yeah. You want to talk to Julie?
Oh, sure. Put her on it.
Yeah, hold on.
Put her on the line.
Julie's got a nice voice.
Hi, Don and Mike.
Hi, Julie. How did Dennis do hang gliding today?
It was great. The whole way up, all you heard was O.S. All the way up, and the way down was O.S.
Man, you really took him up there, and he hang glided.
Yes, he did. We got to thank the Fly Tech boys here for taking us out. It was a great time.
I got to tell you something. You're sweet on Dennis Murphy in a way that we've never heard a girl be sweet on him before.
No, this is amazing, and we're just so glad Dennis is having a good time.
Oh, the night has just begun. We're about. I think we're going to take Dennis back to the original spot of love.
Oh, my. Oh, wow. Well, listen, you be gentle with him tonight, Julie.
Oh, I'm always gentle.
Beautiful. All right, call us Monday and let us know what happens.
Okay, Don and Mike, thank you guys very much.
Okay, bye, Julie.
See ya.
Bye-bye.
Okay. Yeah.
Of course, Dennis, very frustrated. They're not going to talk to me anymore.
But you notice because he had a girl there.
Sure.
For the first time ever.
Yeah, he was mellow about it.
Right.
And this is the best thing that's ever happened to Dennis, and we're glad. This is really good.
I'm still waiting for the other shoe to drop with that girl.
Man, I am too. Who knows what's going to happen? We'll find out on Monday's show.
All right, news and comment now, and here is our friend, Guy Birdley, slacker Buzz Burbank, still broadcasting from his bed.
Yeah, but wearing clothes with a stretch waistband. Now.
Hey, slacker buddy.
Coming right along. Hi, Donna, Mike. Monica Strip Shows, one of the supermarket tabloids, the Star magazine, reports in its latest issue about the relish-laden dress in a story called Monica's Sexy White House Strip Shows.
Yeah, baby. Hey, and now, let me just say, I love the fact that you're getting your news from the tabloids. I mean, I really do.
How many newscasts do you know that start with the words, one of the supermarket tabloids?
Good for you, Buzz.
What about Monica stripping?
Well, the story says Lewinsky got naked for Mr. Clinton's pleasure and that, quote, Monica's favorite blue cocktail dress was lying in a heap on the floor when it was immortalized with the presidential seal of approval.
Oh, my God.
See, that doesn't make sense to me, though, when you hear that lying on the floor, unless he's a really good aim.
Well, maybe he's like Antonio Banderas. Maybe it's raining in there.
Raining Bill.
Raining relish. Chance of downpour of relish today at the Oval Office.
Chance of precipitation, 100%.
The paper goes on to say
Phil Connor? That's what you're doing, right? It's Groundhog Day, right? Chance of departure? 85%.
The paper goes on to say that Monica tells of at least four sexual encounters with Clinton in which there was no actual physical contact after her clothes were off.
But she just danced for him?
Striptease shows. Yeah, apparently so.
Yeah, baby. Now,
Do you think he was playing
with himself?
Is that what they're insinuating, Buzz?
I guess that's what you draw. We have to guess. That's all we can do. They're not more specific, and we're talking about one of the tabloids here.
Okay, there was no physical contact, and she was naked, and there was relish, so I guess maybe that's what happened.
There you go. It could only be that.
Yeah.
The Associated Press, meanwhile, I still look at that occasionally, reports that Monica could
be called
to testify again. After yesterday's testimony, she wasn't told whether she'd have to return or not. And the AP also says the president's famous quote, "I have never had sexual relations with Monica Lewinsky." That comment was made after he asked for and got a definition of the phrase sexual relations. Definition number one.
Just remember, eating ain't cheating.
Mm-hmm. In the Paula Jones case. So technically, the president may be telling the truth if definition number one, as it's called, does not include oral sex.
What is definition number one?
Was that intercourse?
We don't know exactly.
Penetration?
That's what we can assume. Again, we don't know exactly. We've only heard references to this.
Did they get a dictionary definition?
There are legal definitions. There's something called Black's Law Dictionary, and every phrase you can think of is in this dictionary defined for the purpose of lawyers and courts. And so, for legal purposes, every word and phrase has its own special definition.
All right.
Yeah. Breaking news, and not very pleasant news. At least 8 Americans have died in the U.S. embassies in the African countries of Kenya and Tanzania. 81 people killed in all. There are more than 1,700 injuries. Nobody's claimed responsibility yet. President Clinton's promised to track down the bombers.
You know, I know that that's an awful story. And we don't even find out about anybody that's dead.
Right. Yeah.
But you got to know that when Clinton heard that, he probably went, yeah, you know, anything to get him off, to get him off the front page.
Yeah, of course, it'll be about a half an hour where people will look in the other direction of the relish, and then they'll be right back on that relish like a cheap suit.
Sure, or a blue cocktail dress.
That's right.
If it hasn't been hot enough for you in Sacramento or Wichita or wherever you are, consider a trip to Bahrain in the Persian Gulf. The humidity was 90% yesterday when the temperature got up to 129 degrees.
Oh, baby.
That's warmer.
Oh, man, the Arab Sheikh just did that. And it's 90% humidity, it's 120.
That's warmer than usual at 129, even for that place. Summer temperatures in the Gulf usually hover around a cooler 113. Here's a big story.
I bet they don't leave their dogs in the car.
Hot enough to fry an egg on the sidewalk.
Hot enough to fry a dog's brain.
John Travolta is being sued by a gay man who says Travolta helped the Church of Scientology trick him into thinking he could be cured of his condition.
Yes.
This Beverly Hills artist also says, according to Star Magazine again, that the church used Travolta as an example of a homosexual who was converted by Scientology.
Really?
Remember that song he had way back in the 70s?
I'm going to let her in.
There's proof.
I guess I'm going to let him in.
Yay. Well, I don't know when the song was recorded.
All right, now, Buzz.
Yes.
Bend over and spell the word run.
No, thank you, Don.
He knows that it spells R-U-N.
All right.
The Deutsch.
Travolta denied being gay in a 1983 interview with Rolling Stone magazine, but this guy, Michael Pattinson, says Travolta's marriage to Kelly Preston convinced him that it could be done, that he could be straight, too.
Man, they're doing all this to John Travolta, and nobody even has a private investigator on Horseshack.
Mr. Gotcher.
What's the noise he used to make when he would laugh? It was like... I always was a fan of Freddie Boom Boom Washington.
Sure. I liked, what's his name?
Juan Epstein?
Yeah, Juan Epstein. That was my favorite guy because he had a big head.
In his lawsuit, here we are with the big heads again. In his lawsuit, Pattinson says he spent 25 years and $500,000 trying to become hetero and that despite that, he's still gay.
How much money did he say he spent?
$500,000.
$500,000. And
25 years.
Still love D word.
The church calls the lawsuit meritless, and Travolta's lawyer calls it hogwash. So there's their side of the story.
Hogwash.
It is, yeah.
I spent $250,000 that I still just love
D word.
It wasn't $250,000. It was $500,000.
Sorry. Celebrity lawsuits all over the place. Michael Douglas is the target of a multi-$1 million lawsuit by a New York golf caddy. The caddy says Douglas injured his testicles with one of his shots at a tournament nearly a year ago.
All the news is about men's genitals today.
Oh, my God.
Four. I guess he should have said two.
Yeah, two.
Douglas, I said to be shocked to hear about this. His publicist says Douglas was part of that foursome, but says it wasn't his ball that hit the caddies. But the caddy says Douglas did hit the ball and did it before the caddy could get safely out of the way. He says Douglas made no effort to help him once he was injured. He says Douglas just...
Didn't he try to wash the balls?
Stuffed a little money in his pocket
here,
and walked away.
I've got a cold cloth. Let me tend to that area.
Hold on there, Buzz. Quick break, and then we'll be back with more news and comments.
This is the Don and Mike Show.
The Don and Mike Show on 98.1 The Peak.
98.1 The Peak. WPEK.
Jenny Lee's is a fun place. That's what I like about it. We come in, we try to make everybody feel at home.
That's Jenny Lee's owner, Sam Cleckley.
You know, we have a lot of great items. I know you've heard about my grilled chicken and my Philly cheesesteaks. We also have the best burgers in town. They're fresh ground round, they're hand patted. The sandwiches, well, the chicken salad and tuna salad is one of our fortes, and we've been making the best chicken salad in Greenville for years. It's white breast only. It's one of the finest chicken salads you get anywhere. Jenny Lee's is open in the morning downtown at 7 o'clock. We serve breakfast and lunch. We have our two mall stores, which are located in Belk Simpson's at Haywood and McAllister, and there we serve lunch and dinner. We're kind of an alternative to the food works out in the mall.
Visit your friends at Jenny Lee's with three Greenville locations, Belk and McAllister Square, Insignia Plaza 2 downtown, and Belk at Haywood Mall.
Hello, I'm Victor Kiam. Air travelers are discovering earplanes by Travel Smart. Doctor-recommended earplugs that relieve ear discomfort during takeoffs and landings. Here's what Dr. Stanley Cannon says about earplanes.
I had discomfort in my ears every time I flew. I purchased earplanes. My ears never bothered me again. I can't praise earplanes enough.
Get earplanes and children's earplanes by Travel Smart. At airport shops, drug and mass merchants everywhere.
Motormax, great cars and financing guaranteed. We're designed specifically for the automotive customer. Haggle-free pricing. Cars, trucks, minivans, sport utility vehicles handpicked by professional car buyers. So you're guaranteed to get a quality vehicle. Plus, every vehicle is backed by a written warranty. You deserve better. And Motormax is here to help. Even if you thought you couldn't get automotive financing, with your required down payment, we guarantee you'll get financed. Your credit problem is never a problem at Motormax. Recently divorced, young persons wishing to establish credit, discharge bankruptcy, or past credit problems. We can finance you and get you into a better car than you thought possible. And we offer a 48-hour love it or leave it guarantee. If you don't love your vehicle, just bring it back within 48 hours. We want you satisfied. Motormax, great cars and financing guaranteed. In Greenville, Spartanburg, and Hendersonville, North Carolina. Motormax, we're here because you deserve better.
Good afternoon, Caroline Investors. This is Ann.
Hi there, Ann. This is Uncle Doyle. So good to hear your voice. How are you doing?
I'm doing great. How can I help you?
Well, I don't know. I have a few hundred dollars I'd like to invest, earn a little interest. A lot of places tell me I need $1,000, some even $5,000 to start an account. I don't have that kind of money.
Well, Uncle Doyce, you've come to the right place. You see, here at Caroline Investors, we can invest as little as $100 for you at 5% interest with an annual yield of 5.09%. So I believe we can help you.
Sounds good to me, and I think you have several offices. So since I live in Easley, can I go to this office, or will I have to come to Pickens and talk with you?
Well, no, you don't have to come to Pickens. We have very friendly, competent people in all of our offices. Anyone can contact us at 878-2883 in Pickens, 859-8967 in Easley, or 294-0141 in the Brea area of Greenville.
Thanks, Ann. You've been a great help. It was so nice talking with you.
Offered by Prospectus to South Carolina residents only.
Framing Plus is hosting a special See the Light Gallery Night August 8th from 4 till 8 to introduce paintings by renowned artist Thomas Kincaid, known internationally as the Painter of Light. Framing Plus has just acquired the collection and invites you to this exciting premiere. If you already own a Kincaid, you may bring it for an appraisal and take the opportunity to expand your own valuable collection. A Kincaid in your home or office is an expression of refinement and quality, as well as an investment. Come see why Kincaid is called the Painter of Light. Come see the light on Gallery Night and view this prestigious collection. Please call to RSVP this special invitation from Framing Plus, 458-8713, or drop in. Framing Plus is at Maxwell Point near the Winn-Dixie at Woodruff Road and Highway 14. Framing Plus proudly introduces the works of Thomas Kincaid to the Upstate, Saturday, August 8th from 4 till 8. Don't miss this opportunity to visit Framing Plus and come see the light. Refreshments will be served. Call now, 458-8713.
And now, the Starz Movie Channel theme song. Absolutely, positively, nothing but movies. That's what Starz is. 100% commercial-free movies. And Starz is the only place you'll find movies like Liar Liar and Con Air. Starz is what a movie channel should be. So call 1-800-758-5555 and say, I want to see Starz.
This is Mike Hansen.
And Jack Neared on
America on the Road,
where we talk with you about cars, trucks, sport utility vehicles, whatever you're driving or would like to drive.
Saturday mornings at 7:05 right here on WPEK.
You can stay on top of what's going on in the automotive world with America on the Road.
Remember, that's Saturday mornings at 7:05 on 98.1, The Peak, WPEK, news, talk, and sports on FM.
America on the Road.
CNN News on the hour and special reports immediately. 98.1 The Peak. WPEK. News, talk, and sports on FM.
It's the Don and Mike Show.
Now back to the Don and Mike Show on 98.1 The Peak.
Is it possible the two youths...
The two what? What was that word?
What word?
To what?
What?
Did you say utes?
Yeah, two utes.
What is a ute?
Oh, excuse me, Your Honor. Two utes.
They got game. Don Geronimo and Mike O'Mara.
All right, here you go, the toe. Tapping touchdowns right there. We'll take call 100 now.
All right.
We give you something partially made out of plastic. Qualify you for the next big free money show on August 26th. One person wins a big wad, $5,000. That's courtesy of Advantage Title.
That is serious money.
Caller 100 right now, and good luck. Now back to news and comment with Guy Birdley, now wearing pants.
The former Mrs. Tom Cruise, actress Mimi Rogers.
Oh, Major League Yabos. My God.
And likes showing them. She likes showing them.
She's got a great rack.
She's in some movie with that guy, Brian Brown, and I think it's like the masseuse or something, and the whole movie is her just getting a massage from this guy, and you know, you're waiting for her to get up and get off the table because you're like, there they are.
Wow, they are fantastic.
Well, she's suing the Home Shopping Network for $10 million. She blames that network for telling the National Enquirer she went nuts during an appearance there and trashed their green room. Supposedly, she went off after the Home Shopping Network canceled two shows in which she would have tried to sell her $30 Mimi Rogers stretch and flex exercise device.
Oh, I'd like to have that.
Well, the Home Shopping Network, which has no comment now, supposedly told the Enquirer the device was, and I quote, basically a piece of surgical hose with two plastic handles attached.
Oh, nasty stuff.
Yeah, they went on to say she...
Yeah, like they don't sell any other junk on the Home Shopping Network. Yeah,
only quality
stuff.
Like they
got real quality control.
Hey, look at these lovely Dalmatian salt shakers.
Well, the network went on to say that she cursed like a sailor as she tossed some fruit at the wall and flipped over some chairs.
She used to be married to Tom Cruise, right?
That's right. Exactly right.
He knew when to get off that ride.
It's official. Magic Johnson's Magic Hour is up. The 20th television yesterday pulled the plug on the production. The final show was taped yesterday.
Oh, Buzz, and you're looking too good.
Thank you, Magic.
With your pants.
The final show, they're very loose pants, Magic.
Loose pants. They look good, though. They're so
Thank
good.
You.
You're looking too good, Buzz.
You look very
too
comfortable.
Good. Too good.
Those
pants, they're loose, but they look good. Goodbye.
Goodbye. The final new show was taped yesterday and aired last night, and starting tonight, it's reruns, so I guess you could look at it as the best of Magic.
Hey, and listen, everybody, those really are the best, especially if they show the first week of shows.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah. Before they tried to really fix it. I mean, the first couple of shows, when he was out there just being Magic.
And they thought it might just work, and it failed miserably.
Yeah, because he's so personable and everything. Yeah, those are worth watching.
Stand by for a quality entertainment program. The reruns run out on Monday, September 7th, so you have that much time left. And even his win-a-date with Sheila E. promotion fizzled out as he tried to save the show.
Hell, our get Dennis Murphy late week worked out better than that.
Sure
much
did.
Better.
For
much
my
better.
Money, Sheila E. really the best thing about that program.
Yeah.
Just looking at Sheila E. Sheila E. still manages to look stunning.
What about Phil E.?
Philly.
Yeah.
Hey, boy.
Hey, boy.
20th Television decided to pull the plug, not just because of the poor ratings, they say, but because a lot of the affiliates were moving the magic hour into the wee hours of the morning.
Two?
But wait, there's more about Geraldo. He says he has his eye on Tom Brokaw's chair.
All right now, Geraldo. Let's get a reality check here, okay?
Well, he tells TV Guide he wants to be the news anchor for the next millennium. Describing himself, Geraldo says, and I quote, "I wear my heart on my sleeve. My hair is too long. I'm an ex-hippie. I have tattoos. I'm Puerto Rican with a mustache and a broken nose. I don't look like those other anchor guys. I don't hang out with those guys."
I like that. I like Geraldo as our next. I do.
Listen,
you know me. I'm the world's biggest Geraldo fan.
I'll take a Canadian giving me the news. But I'm not going to watch a Puerto Rican read the news to me.
Oh,
I'm sorry. I got some standards, okay?
That's where you draw the line.
Right, correct. Let him go out and get all upset about Jerry Seinfeld, like all the other Puerto Ricans.
Tom Brokaw.
98.1 The Peak. WPEK.
On a hot summer day, all you want is water. Nothing quenches thirst like the taste of pure Le Bleu bottled water. You may have seen it in your convenience or grocery store, but now Le Bleu is available in 5-gallon bottles for the home or office. Le Bleu bottled water is drawn from 600-foot-deep artesian wells in the Piedmonts of North Carolina. It's the official bottled water of the Carolina Panthers and Winston Cup, and will be the official bottled water of the Charlotte Hornets next year. Le Bleu has a unique patented 5-step purification process that takes out everything, leaving only pure H2O. It's a process other water bottling companies don't bother to go through. Le Bleu tastes good, and it's the highest quality bottled water you'll find anywhere. It's available right here in the Upstate, so get yourself a cooler and 2 5-gallon containers of delicious Le Bleu ultra pure bottled water for your home or office. Try it out for the next 2 weeks with no obligation and absolutely free. In the Spartanburg area, call 595-0055, and in Greenville, call 268-4466 for Le Bleu bottled water.
If you're looking for a mortgage lender with your best interest in mind, then look no further. Franklin American Mortgage Company specializes in FHA and VA lending and offers the best service and interest rates around. Here's Lisa Jakowski with Franklin American to tell you more.
Whether you are the CEO of a corporation, the owner of a small business, or just starting your first job, our goal is to make sure you receive the utmost in customized service. Each loan program is tailored to suit our clients' individual and specific needs. At Franklin American Mortgage Company, our team is precise and efficient at meeting the multiple deadlines involved with your home purchase or refinance. For us, it's all about exceeding your expectations. We enjoy making Greenville our top priority.
Visit Franklin American today, conveniently located at 15 Whitsitt Street in downtown Greenville, or call 467-1900. That's 467-1900. Franklin American Mortgage Company. Lower interest rates, more service.
After an off-season of shakeups in the front office and on the roster, the Panthers take the field Saturday in their preseason opener against Jacksonville. I'm Bill Rosensky with a preview in this Piedmont Technology Group Panthers Update.
The Carolina Panthers are experts at moving the ball down the field. And United Van Lines is an expert at moving you and your possessions. They're the industry leader for moving and storage. So it's only natural that Horn Storage is your United Van Lines agent in North Carolina. Horn Storage is number one in residential relocations. Don't trust your worldly possessions with anything less than the best. Horn Storage. Call 1-800-756-0127. 1-800-756-0127.
If you're looking for a new Ford, Oldsmobile, or Jeep, there is only one place in the Upstate to shop for all three. That's Edwards Auto Sales in Walhalla. Bob Edwards has new Oldsmobile 88s, Intrigues, and Cutlasses, all with 1.9% financing for 36 months with credit approval. Plenty of Ford F-150s and the new 99 F-250s in stock, both regular and extended cabs. Jeep Cherokees and Grand Cherokees available at closeout prices. Over 6 acres of new and used Oldsmobiles, Fords, and Jeeps. That's Edwards Auto Sales, Highway 28, Walhalla. We'll be right back.
Jacksonville comes to Erickson Stadium tomorrow night for the Panthers' preseason opener, and Carolina will unveil its new offensive style. Now, most of the players are the same, but the coordinator is different, Gil Haskell. And he gives us an idea of what he's looking for in this first game.
First of all, I want to see how fast we play. In other words, if you're learning, if it's new and you have a lot of plays, you're thinking more than playing, and I don't want that to happen. I want them to feel free with what they're doing and play fast. The other thing, I don't want any turnovers at all, drop balls, fumbles, or penalties. When I used to coach high school and I coached college, coach pro, you cannot do that, and we will try to eliminate that right from the start.
Look for Kerry Collins and the rest of the first team to play nearly a half. That won't be the case for the defensive starting 11. Maybe two series and that'll be it. For those on the fence trying to make the roster, Coach Dom Capers says one way to make an impression is on special teams.
We're looking and evaluating to try to decide who will be, give us a chance to upgrade our coverage units. And I've told the squad that there'll be a number of players that will make this team based off their special teams ability, and Saturday night will be their first opportunity to go out and exhibit that.
The bottom line, to evaluate talent, it begins tomorrow night. I'm Bill Rosinski on the Carolina Panthers Radio Network.
98.1, The Peak, is WPEK, Seneca, Greenville, Spartanburg, Anderson, for news, talk, and sports on FM.
CNN Radio News, I'm Stan Case. Medicine, security teams, and FBI investigators are all on their way to East Africa to join the relief effort following deadly terrorist bombings at embassies in Kenya and Tanzania. At least 40 people are dead in Nairobi, 9 more killed in Dar es Salaam. The Kenya blast injured more than 1,100 people. Red Cross officials say sounds beneath the rubble suggest survivors are still trapped by the debris. Local hospitals have been overwhelmed by the number of patients who've been brought in for treatment. Both President Clinton and Secretary of State Madeleine Albright call the bombings cowardly. They're vowing to track down those responsible.
We are going to protect our people and our values, and we're certainly not going to be intimidated by those who value nothing but hatred and death.
Albright was in Rome when the blasts occurred. She's now on her way back to the United States. Why the embassies in Kenya and Tanzania? We ask Robert Oakley, the former U.S. ambassador to Zaire.
These targets were chosen because the perpetrators believed they were easy targets. They could get into the country, plan what they needed to do, carry it out, and get out of the country safely. I think that's the reason that they were picked, and no other reason.
There's been no claim of responsibility, and State Department officials refuse to speculate about suspects. Dozens of FBI agents, most of them explosives experts and evidence response teams, left Washington late today to join the investigation. A setback for independent counsel Ken Starr, the federal judge overseeing the Monica Lewinsky grand jury, says there is evidence Starr's office probably leaked grand jury testimony illegally. Judge Norma Holloway Johnson says Starr must now overcome that evidence. CNN Radio legal analyst Greta Van Susteren says it's an important finding.
This talks about, in essence, poisoning the grand jury system. This is not an insignificant matter.
Starr has denied any illegal leaks. This is CNN Radio News.
Say you ran a small business.
I don't. My small business runs me.
Perfect. Then you're ready to call 1-800-5-PITNEY and join the revolution.
What revolution?
The one that grows your business.
Do tell.
Well, 1-800-5-PITNEY is the number to call to order the personal post office from Pitney Bowes.
A postage meter for small business? I like that.
Then you'll love the personal post office. It means instantly metered mail and no more going out for stamps. So you have more time to turn your small business into a big one.
Wow. Something that turns small business into big business. That's a revolution.
It also refills by phone 24 hours a day, so it works when you do.
Look, it even adds a personal message. That's so cool.
And all for about the cost of a cup of coffee a day.
Okay, I'm sold.
Good. Call 1-800-5-PITNEY and you'll get a 90-day free trial.
What's the number?
1-800-5-PITNEY. The personal post office. It's a business revolution made simple.
Thanks.
Customer satisfaction is standard equipment at Consolidated Tires. That's what you get.
At Consolidated.
Consolidated Tires, we sell high-quality tires like the Uniroyal brand with proven durability, rugged traction, and great value. So we don't have to pressure you into buying more than you need. Better yet, at Consolidated Tires, we'll help you decide which Uniroyal tires are best for your vehicle, your needs, and your budget. So come to Consolidated Tire and Auto Service, where customer satisfaction is standard equipment. We have two locations in Greenville to serve you, South Pleasantburg Drive and downtown on Westfield Street. Or visit our new Greenwood location. You'll get the service and quality Uniroyal tires for your car or light truck. Uniroyal Tires, driving dependability home.
Customer satisfaction, standard equipment, and Consolidated Tires, that's what you get.
To many Greenvillians, it seems the Bilo Center has sprung up overnight. But developer Carl Scheer remembers the long road traveled to making the arena a reality. Trace that road in the August cover story of Greenville Business and Living. The Bilo Center, 20 years in the making. And in the next issue of Greenville Business and Living, what's it really like to be an interracial couple in the upstate? Dr. Robert McNamara, sociology professor at Furman University, interviews local couples in interracial marriages. We may not be a fashion hub, but in our article, Fall Fashion from Madison Avenue to Greenville, you'll see through the eyes of prominent Greenvillians what's hot for this year, no matter where you live. All of this and much more in the August issue of Greenville Business and Living magazine, on sale now at area bookstores. Don't miss a single exciting issue. Subscribe today by calling 271-1105 with 66% off the newsstand price. Anyone can bring you the news. Only Greenville Business and Living brings Greenville to life.
We want our house to have the hottest look around. Where's the best place to go for the look we want?
Looking for some answers, advice you know is true.
Come to your Sherwin-Williams store today. You'll save $4.50 a gallon on Super Paint exterior and $5 a gallon on Super Paint interior paint. Plus, save $5 a gallon on Woodscape's exterior stain.
And only the best will do.
WPEK is testing its emergency alert system equipment. The EAS provides timely emergency warnings. WPEK serves the Seneca-Greenville operational area. This concludes this test of the emergency alert system.
This is Charlie Mack. Join me for all the excitement of Gamecock football here on 98.1 The Peak, WPEK.
On the other side, out of the obscurity of Huntington, West Virginia, and into the spotlight of life in the National Football League.